You still couldn't pay me to watch one of their a cappella shows. What inspired you to create this amazing ballet?
I'm really inspired by the theme of my dad paying any attention to me at all.
Now at the end, I hear she just put the game up on the big screen.
I don't know where she gets it.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here toll free. 855-450-FREE is our number. We, tonight, includes me, Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
And you can join us online, of course, at freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features that we have waiting for you on the site. And you can join us on Skype here in the studio at username lrn.fm. So there's multiple ways for you to get interactive and get on the air here to bring up whatever is on your mind. That is the point of Free Talk Live. Of course, we always bring things to the table to discuss. And the continually deteriorating situation in Greece, I think, is probably one of the more pressing situations. It's certainly looking good for people who are invested in Bitcoin, or at the very least for people who invested not at the peak of Bitcoin, because Bitcoin has been as high as $1,000.
Oh, yeah.
But in recent months, it has been sort of floating in the 230 range. Then just within the last 2 weeks or 2 or 3 weeks, it's shot up basically to what is now over $260 per Bitcoin today. And it's, you know, I'm no expert on money matters, but it certainly seems like you can attribute this to what's happening in Greece.
That seems fair. There's a lot of positive. There's a lot of positive news surrounding Bitcoin, but the whole Grecian thing. There was some article that came out that claimed that there's, you know, Greeks are flocking to Bitcoin. I don't know whether that's true.
I have the
or
article
not.
Right here, as a matter of fact.
Do they have any citations?
Why, yes. They have talked to people at the various different Bitcoin exchanges who can identify who's coming to use their website to transfer their government money into into Bitcoin. Here's a story from CNN Money.
I'd love to know that because it seems like it would be beneficial to the Bitcoin community if somebody just wrote an article that said Greeks are flocking to Bitcoin, right? Like, so in that case, that's one way. But I mean, yeah, I mean, if you can find a lot of people coming from, you know, the geographic area known as Greece, or, you know, a lot of people with names like Tryphon, Snappalopoulos, right? Like those kind of things, then yeah, I suppose I'll go for that then.
With bank doors slammed shut, frantic Greeks are turning to online trading platforms to see if the digital money Bitcoin is a better bet than the euro. The world's largest Bitcoin exchanges tell CNN Money they've seen a surge of business from Greece. 10 times as many Greeks are registering to trade Bitcoins on the German marketplace, Bitcoin.de, than usual. And by the way, this story is actually, I had it yesterday. We didn't get a chance to get around to it, but this was published a day or two ago, so you know, it's probably even more so today. But again, 10 times as many are registering. Bitcoin trades from Greece have shot up 79% from their 10-week average on Bitstamp, the world's third largest exchange. So shooting up 79% from a 10-week average just recently. Even trading platforms in China are getting interest from folks in Greece. Lake BTC, headquartered in Shanghai, is seeing a 40% increase in visitors using computers in Greece. Over the weekend, the Polish exchange Bitcurex got flooded with emails from Greeks. Among their questions, is Bitcoin a legal currency in the EU? Can I use Bitcurex as a bank account? Do you have a Bitcoin ATM network in Greece? All lots of, you know, introductory kind of questions to Bitcoin.
I imagine there, you know, there's probably as many people in Greece who are into Bitcoin as there are any place in sort of the Western world, right? Mm-hmm. And then those people,
which means there aren't that many.
Yeah, right? not that many. Right. But and the ones that are male and young, right? But those young males have moms and dads and aunts and uncles, and they have, you know, families that they love and care about. And some of those families are saying, you know, this whole banking thing's getting real scary, and they're suddenly beginning to listen to these young males and their, you know, magic internet money that has so far not captured their attention for whatever reason, but at the same time, it hasn't collapsed, right? Like, there's a lot of people running around that believe that when Mt. Gox, this is mtgox.com went down that suddenly Bitcoin disappeared from the face of the map.
No.
They hear some news stories now and then about it, but they, you know, they're not paying that much attention. They figure they're eulogies. And not so. Bitcoin, the program, remains stable. The largest alternative currency on the planet, the most valuable individual unit of currency, and an easy way to send and receive money all over the world, and for you to control your own banking. However, yes, there was a crooked website called Mt. Gox, and it's gone and in bankruptcy. In the same way that there have been crooked banks who have gone away.
Or Ponzi scheme people or whoever, right?
I mean, right, one crooked bank doesn't make the U.S. dollar bad, even if it was the first and largest bank. Yeah, it can deliver a blow, but that doesn't change the fact that Bitcoin's still here and still a viable alternative.
BitCurex has now started marketing directly to Greeks on its website. Sign up at BitCurex and trade for 3 months for free. No fees for Greece.
Nice.
That's what they're doing.
That's great.
Yeah. For those wondering, yes, Bitcoins can be spent legally in Europe, and yes, a digital Bitcoin wallet can be used as sort of access from anywhere bank account. The simplest way to understand Bitcoin is to think of it as electronic cash, right? CNN money. You can spend it using any smartphone or computer. And further, there's no limit on how much Bitcoin you can spend or how much you can, you know, move around or whatever. Right now, there's a 60 euro withdrawal limit that has been applied to Greece's ATM locations. So over the weekend, we'd reported that there was a run on the ATMs where people were literally lining up. In some cases, they were very long lines. There's different photos you can see out there. There's some photos with just two or three people standing in front of an ATM, and then there's other photos with long lines, like going around the corners of buildings kind of lines at ATMs. These guys were tapping out ATMs. Over 500 ATM locations over the weekend were completely tapped out of cash. So now, as of Monday, the banking cartel people in Greece decided to put a 60 euro withdrawal limit. Imagine only being able to pull out $60, three $20 bills from your ATM. How would that affect your ability to, you know, run your life if you don't have cash on hand?
That's barely enough to make it through the day.
Yeah. So it's ridiculous, which of course means, Mark, that more people are going to be standing in more lines, right? Because if there's a 60 euro limit, I'm presuming it's per ATM machine, or maybe it's per account. I don't know how they, you know, how they cap that. But either way, that means everybody's going to go to, one person who would have gone out to withdraw $500 is now going to have to go out 5 days a week to try to withdraw anything even close to that.
Now, as far as their banking system in Greece, is it a nationalized bank, or do they have privatized banks like we do here in the U.S.?
I'm not sure about that. I know they do have the Bank of Greece, but I suspect they also have semi-private banks, just like in the U.S. Most places do have that.
Right.
But they, you know, obviously they're all working together at this point, and there's a bank holiday, as we talked about last night, that was supposed to be just for Monday, but now the bank holiday is going to go all the way through next Monday, or rather this coming Monday, because there's a vote that's going to be happening there, a vote of the people in Greece to decide whether or not they want to go along with the austerity measures that are being demanded by the country's creditors. So they're leaving it up to the voters to decide in this particular case.
Now here's a question. So now Bitcoin is basically coming to the rescue, the way I see it. You know, they're giving the people another option that wasn't really there. What if this had happened 50 years ago? Which, you know, and it has happened in history before. What would be the next steps the people would take? Would someone have to step in and take control of the situation, or would another country, or of course, Greece has been getting bailed out from especially Germany and whatnot. But I mean, you know, what would have happened if Bitcoin wasn't around to save the day?
Well, I mean, look at the history of the crashing and burning of various different government currencies around the world. It usually gets pretty ugly, mm-hmm. right? And Bitcoin isn't going to save the day. It's not going to be popular enough, fast enough to save everyone in Greece, but it certainly is going to give some people a way to transfer their euros into something different.
So most of this problem that's occurring in Greece has been produced by bankers and by politicians. Like,
that's right.
Almost entirely. There's some responsibility that goes to the people in that they advocate for government spending while refusing to pay for taxes. I guess that avoiding taxes is a national sport in Greece. That's what I've read. It's not that I'm against people choosing to avoid taxes. I'm against you advocating for spending while choosing to avoid taxes. I think that that's what the problem is. Bitcoin can address all of the issues of the bankers and the government, and I'll tell you why.
All right, we'll come back with more on Bitcoin, what's happening in Greece. There's some shocking detail about restrictions. I told you about the ATM restrictions. There are even worse restrictions being put on businesses, and I'll explain that coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
Every summer we go to Canyon Woods. Love getting outside. Love the hiking. Hate the itching and irritation from poison ivy, bug bites, all the things that keep me inside. So I need something strong.
Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing is clinically proven with the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief of itching and irritation with 7 moisturizers to help heal skin.
I finally have the relief I need.
Hey, Jan, check this out.
On my way.
Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
Discover how deep your American roots go for free this 4th of July weekend. Go to TryAncestry.com to get free access through July 5th. Visit TryAncestry.com anytime this Wednesday through Sunday, and you'll have free access to our collection of records from the original 13 colonies and with a new visual story experience. Celebrate this 4th of July and take advantage of this free access weekend. Visit TryAncestry.com. That's TryAncestry.com. TryAncestry.com.
If you're worried about your health and you're tired of the nasty side effects of harsh drugs or antibiotics, then look no further. Supernatural Silver is the answer. Supernatural Silver is a powerful immune system enhancer that can be used every day to help keep you healthy and well with none of those nasty side effects. It's extremely safe for use internally as well as topically. And Supernatural Silver is hundreds of times more effective than colloidal or ionic silver. It is perfect for use in the sinuses, eyes, ears, and on any wound or skin issue. Supernatural Silver is also extremely effective when taken orally and can help fight off bacteria, viruses, and mold that may be overwhelming your immune system. Go to SupernaturalSilver.com, SupernaturalSilver.com, and use the promo code SILVER2015 for 30% off of your entire order. And give yourself and your loved ones a fighting chance with Supernatural Silver.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Continuing to follow the economic situation that is developing over in Greece, just because, you know, it's fascinating, like a train wreck is fascinating. You can't look away from it, even though there are people who are in very dire economic circumstances. As you'll learn here in a little bit, I'll share a story about how this is affecting businesses in Greece, because there's some pretty serious controls that have been put on the banking system there that is really going to really hurt people over there in Greece. So, I mean, I certainly don't relish what is happening to the people in Greece. That's very unfortunate. But there are some good sides or some silver linings to what's happening there, and that is that the price of Bitcoin has gone up, and further, that people are getting interested in Bitcoin. You know, the necessity being the mother of invention. In this case, you don't have to invent Bitcoin, but you can invent the idea to try something new, right? If you cannot pull more than 60 euro out of the local ATM on a daily basis, that might incentivize you to find another alternative, to find something else to use to get your bills paid and to, you know, get business taken care of.
As I was saying previously, this is really a fault of the bankers and the politicians. So, you know, I mean, it's these currencies, which are backed by nothing. They are printed into existence by central bankers. This much is clear and obvious. All it takes is a little bit of time to take a look. Politicians spend with impunity because they're sort of in bed with these folks. And mm-hmm. that's that. Now, the reason we have runs on banks, I mean, think about it for a second. Why is there a run on the bank? Why is there a limited amount of money you can withdraw? Why in the world should a politician care for 1 second whether you have your money in a bank or don't have your money in a bank? Well, the reason is because of fractional reserve lending laws. The politicians tell their friends, the bankers, hey, don't worry. You don't have to keep everybody's stuff on. I'm doing my Bill Clinton. You don't have to have everybody's money on site. All you have to do is just go ahead and have 10% or something like that.
Yeah, isn't it like 1/9 or something? They can lend out 9 times as much as they have.
It depends where. And not even in the vault, just in savings. It depends where and all that sort of thing. So then people run off, and they when 20% of the people at a given bank want their money back, the bank has, you know, only half as much money to service them.
Right. Right.
And that's a problem. Now, you know, the very fact that banks run their business the way they run their business is near criminal, in my opinion. But it's fine if you want to put your money in a bank where people, where they do fractional reserve banking, then fine. You should be able
you
to do that.
You can't avoid it.
Well, you can't, but you can avoid putting your money in the bank.
You can avoid that unless you want to do business, in which case you pretty much have to have a bank account.
Yep, that much is true. You could just choose to take Bitcoin, I suppose, but you're going to have a difficult time doing that business. You're going to have a very limited audience. So essentially,
you were going to explain how Bitcoin limits politicians and bankers from screwing us. I want you to do that in a moment. But I also want to let you, our listener, know if you're in the U.S. or Canada, I'm sorry if you're in Greece, but if you're in the U.S. or Canada, you can get Bitcoin from expresscoin.com. They make it easy, it's fast, it's safe, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, and you can get cryptocurrency with money order or check. Just get started at expresscoin.com. They've got an app that you can download to your smartphone if you want, or again, you can just use their website. It makes it easy, and you can use coupon code FTL, and you'll save on up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency. You'll pay 0% when you transfer there over at expresscoin.com with code FTL as your coupon code. So once again, Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, they've got them. Go to expresscoin.com. By the way, it's Ian, Conan, and Mark here in the studio. So Mark, what were you going to explain about Bitcoin limiting politicians and bankers?
Yeah, what Bitcoin does is it makes it so bankers can't just print money into existence and politicians can't make deals with them.
They absolutely can print money into existence and Bitcoin's still there. That hasn't stopped them from doing that. Are you talking about in some ideal world where everyone's using Bitcoin?
I suppose that's what I mean. What I really mean is that if you use Bitcoin, no politician or banker can make new bitcoins on their own.
That's certainly true.
Okay.
Whatever money you have in Bitcoin is essentially protected by virtue of the fact that it is Bitcoin from being molested by politicians.
Right. And, you know, I mean, if you... Yeah, I mean, so Bitcoin...
You can't get a Bitcoin haircut like they did in Cyprus, where the politicians came in and just knocked 45% off the top of every single bank account. I don't know if it was everyone, but a whole bunch of the bank accounts in Cyprus.
But right. But they may decide to attack big companies who actually deal in Bitcoin. You know,
they might, but that's speculative. I mean, they haven't thus far. Dell Computer, Wikipedia. I mean, these are all big companies that are taking Bitcoin.
But how much Bitcoin is actually a part of the money that they're making?
It's a small portion.
So it's not. It's and a lot of these old politicians who, like we're just talking about, these old folks that don't really even understand what Bitcoin is. They might not have gotten on the bandwagon yet. This is like any technology. The politicians take a good 10 or so years to actually catch on before they start molesting the hell out of
them. Look what's happened to Bitcoin in just the last 5 years. Mm-hmm. I mean, give Bitcoin another 5 years, and politicians can never catch up.
I mean, look, yeah, exactly. Look how long it's taken for them to catch on to the internet, and now they're trying to do the push their net neutrality down our throats, or SIPA, whatever, NIPA, CREPA.
Well, they're still having trouble figuring out how to tax the internet.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I do have my Bitcoins in a bank, that's something you can do. You can keep your Bitcoins safe in a bank if that's what you want to do.
What does that mean?
I've got a safe deposit box at a bank and, a jump drive with my Bitcoin logon information for my cold storage wallet, right?
It's encrypted, not like somebody could just grab that jump drive and be able to access your Bitcoins.
No, they could grab the jump drive and attempt to prevent me from accessing it, but it's actually on other jump drives around, too.
Yeah.
It's just copied there. But you can use a bank to keep Bitcoin safe, and I expect that to be the case, is that my Bitcoins are safe because they're in that bank. But that's not true.
The Bitcoins are safe because they're encrypted. The bank is just one of a few different storage locations you've decided to put that encrypted file.
One that's safe, right? I mean,
it's not safe from being raided by the feds. If the feds want to go and take everything in your safe deposit box, that bank's going to let them walk right in. It's the fact that you encrypted it that keeps it safe.
Encryption certainly is a much bigger deal than the fact that it's in a bank. But, if my house burns down or whatever, and I happen to have one of the fobs, one of the jump drives in my house, which generally is not the case, or if the house of a friend that I have one of these fobs at burns down, right, I'm not out of luck because I have one at a bank. It's unlikely that, three of the places that I've got these will all burn down the same evening. So I'm in pretty good shape as far as that goes.
Yeah, but the bank doesn't deserve credit for any of that. It's just another place. That's all.
I think there's a value to banks. Banks are a place to keep your money safe. And when a Bitcoin bank comes around that can be trusted.
Keep your money safe from the average criminal, but not from the government.
And Mark's not talking about like a bank that is giving out loans and stuff, but I'm sure that they do that as well. But he's more of a security deposit location Your items, your precious items are.
Before. I know what it's all about.
Well, what a
but
bank
I also know it ain't safe from the government.
Right.
So savings accounts and savings accounts are frankly ludicrous. A checking account is a service that you should pay for. Mm. If you're not paying for your checking account, here's a surprise for you folks. If you ain't paying for the product, you are the product.
Well, they're loaning the money out. Mm-hmm. That's the payment for it.
They're not even loaning the money out.
Well, they're not loaning it to me, but they might be loaning it to somebody. And so they're making the money off of someone.
Right.
They're using it to put it against the amount that they have to have to make more loans.
All right, we'll come back with more here. The latest on the Greece situation. What's happening to the business owners there? They are hurting big time. We'll explain why here in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Do good people ever want to call an attorney just to find out if they're right or wrong? But every time you think about calling an attorney, what are you forced to think about first? Money. If you could call as often as you wanted and talk as long as you need without a bill, would you call? Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Hi, I'm Daryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online poker site?
Do you have a poker sound effect? Because we have a new advertiser, swcpoker.eu.
Brought to you by the same guys that did Seals with Clubs.
Now they're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. The Krill leaderboard is active now. It's Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, swcpoker.eu.
Get on over to swcpoker.eu and start playing now.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
It's the Onion Radio News. All seven deadly sins were committed at a church bake sale. This is Doyle Redland reporting. Avarice, sloth, envy, lust, gluttony, pride, and wrath. All seven of the fabled deadly sins were committed on Sunday at the twice annual bake sale at St. Mary's of the Immaculate Conception Church. According to St. Mary's treasurer, Beth Ellen Coyle, church-sponsored events are a notorious breeding ground for these treasonous acts against the Lord God.
This is supposed to be about the glorification of God, not violating His word. Do that and you're no better than that cheap strumpet Melissa Wyckoff with those sinful chocolate cookies of hers.
The seven deadly sins were first outlined in the 5th century by Gregory the Great, who himself was, as indicated by his very name, toying dangerously with the sin of pride. Doyle Redland for the Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. We have plenty of time for you and your calls and thoughts here. 855-450-FREE is our number. That's 855-450-3733. We've also got Skype. Skype on in here at username lrn.fm. Joining you in studio, it's me, Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
And you can also, of course, check out some cool stuff online like Peacekeeper. Peacekeeper 1.0 was released late last year, and it is a great idea. It's a concept of building a decentralized network of emergency responders. The idea being that if there's a fire or a medical emergency, an abduction or something like that, you can send a notice on your phone and then have other peacekeepers, other people with the same app that are your friends or family or neighbors, respond, meaning they can respond probably quicker than 911 could. Maybe they'll respond in a more humane fashion than, say, a cop showing up and shooting your dog to death or throwing a grenade in your baby's crib. These are not things that are likely to happen if it's your loved ones who are the ones who are responding. So Peacekeeper is a brilliant concept. Unfortunately, there were some bugs with the first version of the app. They want to redo it. They want to make Peacekeeper 2.0, add in some really cool new features, like actually opening it up to where anyone with the Peacekeeper app can receive alerts and respond, adding in some GPS features and more. It's really a great concept. And in fact, it's more than just an app. It's a movement. It's a revolutionary system that is designed to challenge the status quo, can allow ordinary people to stand up and be heroes. If you want to see peace, excuse me, if you want to see Peacekeeper 2.0 revolutionize what protection means, contribute to their Indiegogo campaign today. Just go to pk.freetalklive.com. PK stands for Peacekeeper. It'll take you straight to the Indiegogo page. So pk.freetalklive.com for Peacekeeper 2.0's Indiegogo fundraiser. You can get perks when you join up with that, of course. pk.freetalklive.com. Back to the story here. Bitcoin. Is it going to save Greece? Well, probably not. But it certainly could help protect some people from having their savings completely ravaged by whatever scheme the politicians and bankers in Greece cook up next. There's been a pretty serious situation developing there, and it's not just over the last few weeks, but over the last few weeks it has been getting more serious, even more so within the last several days, and the price of Bitcoin has been responding. And that's because there's a significant uptick in the interest in Bitcoin in Greece. 79%, in fact, according to Bitcoin.de, that's a German Bitcoin marketplace, Bitcoin trades from Greece have shot up 79% from their 10-week average. Even in China, there's a 40% increase in visitors using computers in Greece on, again, Bitcoin exchange websites. And so a little bit more here about the way Bitcoin can be of assistance to some of these folks. There's a lot of real basic questions that are being asked about Bitcoin by people in Greece. And so these guys are fielding that. So, for instance, it is legal to spend Bitcoins in Europe and anywhere, generally, for that matter. I don't know if it's been – there must be some countries where it's been completely outlawed, but I don't know
which ones. There's some with some very tight regulations that are basically outlawing Bitcoin. But I think Thailand is one of them that comes to mind.
The simplest way to understand Bitcoin, writes CNN Money, is to think of it as electronic cash. You can spend it using any smartphone or computer. But that's not the hard part. First, it's incredibly difficult to obtain Bitcoins. There's a single Bitcoin ATM in all of Greece. So I was wondering about that earlier, was how many of these Bitcoin vending machines...
That was
Bitcoin
a question
ATMs
that somebody asked. Is there an ATM network?
Yeah, that was my question, actually, a couple days ago on the show. And turns out, only one. I wonder how long the lines are at that particular ATM.
Well, I imagine there's people doing a brisk business through local bitcoins. Yep. Is it localbitcoins.com?
I think so. The most common method, buying them in an online marketplace, generally requires sending a wire transfer from a bank. But banks in Greece are closed all week.
Not so with expresscoin.com. You can do it with a money order or a check.
Not if you're in Greece, I'm afraid, Mark. Only if you're in the U.S. or
That's
Canada.
True.
It's not impossible, though. Now, just to be clear, if you are in Greece and know someone in the U.S. and Canada who could send a money order or a check to Express Coin, that might possibly work. I'm not sure how legal it would be, but it might work. It's not impossible, though. The exchange Bitcoin.de said some Greeks are managing to get Bitcoins because they still get access to online banking. Meanwhile, Lake BTC in China said Greeks can try to find local Lake bankers who are willing to sell some of their Bitcoin stash using paper cash or PayPal. The second challenge... There aren't many ways to spend them in Greece anyway. According to one publicly maintained registry, Bitcoin Maps, there are only half a dozen spots in Athens that accept Bitcoin as payment. Among them, a family restaurant called Angel Tavern, a head and neck surgeon, and a yacht rental company. As CNN Money documented last year, it's difficult to live entirely on Bitcoin, even in high-tech, modern New York City.
Yeah, you can go through... Amazon, for instance, has lots of food, but its food isn't... You know, fresh vegetables and, grass-fed meats, generally, that I know of. I mean, I haven't spent a lot of time on Amazon looking for meats and bread, but, vegetables. But you can get things like food that comes in boxes and bags. You can get that from Amazon.
You can, and obviously you can't pay Bitcoin directly on Amazon, but you can with purse.freetalklive.com. You can get up to 25% off or more over at Amazon.
Right, you can get the food you need, some of the food you need, food that you'll survive on at 25% off. There's no other place you're going to get 25% off on Amazon products.
Yeah, period. I mean, where can you get that kind of discount on anything generally, unless it's some sort of crazy closeout sale, somebody going out of business kind of liquidation sale.
Right.
So again, this is real. Purse is a real thing. I use it frequently. In fact, I was just using it today. Purse.freetalklive.com. When you sign up through that link, Free Talk Live gets a cut. Let's go to the phones here. I have to apologize to our callers. We are in a kind of a rudimentary call screening situation here. The internet is down at our network, the Genesis Communications Network, so we can still take your calls, and they will still be given to me as far as, you know, the information about who's on the line. But we're doing it via text message here, so it's a little bit
different our best
than normal. So let's go to our first caller. Libertarian Banker is on the line, calling from somewhere anonymous. You're on Free Talk Live, Libertarian Banker with Ian, Conan, and Mark.
Hey, guys. How's it going tonight?
Good, sir. Go ahead.
Good thing Cantwell's not there to answer that.
Go ahead with your thoughts.
But anyway, listen, I wanted to talk about fractional reserve banking. Mark earlier said, did his best Bill Clinton voice to, demonstrate how fractional reserve banking came into being. And I'd like to remind you that fractional reserve banking actually was a product of the free market. Blacksmiths would house gold in their facilities and issue certificates for that gold. And eventually the blacksmiths found out that, hey, I could just issue more permits than there are gold, and, you know, I won't get in any trouble as long as I can fulfill all the orders of people that are coming in. So, you know, fractional reserve banking, the concept of it is not a government concept. It's actually one that was invented in the free market.
Well, I'm not sure that
so that's the first point of it.
Essentially lying about what you have in your vault is a product of the free market.
That's fraud.
It's a scam.
Right. I mean, that's what the runs on the blacksmith's vault would be about, is people are like, he doesn't have all the money he's supposed to have because he's lent it out or whatever. I mean, another product of the free market is certificates of deposit. I'm sure if you're a banker that you're familiar with these, where somebody gives you money for 3 months, 6 months, a year, 2 years. I think you can go on up to 3 years. I'm not 100% sure. And they say, and you say, I'll give you 1.5% if you give me this money for 3 years. Now, that is a fair, just, and equitable exchange, because I'm not putting money in your bank with the expectation that I can pull it out anytime I want. Now, you could have different rules on the CD thing. You can say, I'll let you take the money out if you want, and you'll take this penalty on, you know, the interest or whatever it is. And those things are all fine and dandy, but it's really just a big fat lie, don't you think? I mean, this whole fractional reserve.
Yeah, absolutely. But, the CD idea, and I've called in and talked to you about this before, Mark. But the CD idea is the same thing, man. So if Ian has a CD with me and Mark has a CD with me and Mark wants his money, but guess what? I loaned Mark's money out. Well, I'm going to give you Ian's money. And then if Ian wants his money, I'm going to give you Conan's money. So I'm not keeping your money, you know, safe in a vault. I'm loaning it out.
But that's part of the understanding that you...
That's fractional reserve banking.
Yeah, I suppose you're right on the point you're making is true. However, you can just say, look, you loaned it to me for 3 years. You can't have it back because it's loaned out.
Thanks, Libertarian Banker. I appreciate it. That's part of the understanding of a CD. You know that that's what they're doing with your money, and that's why you get paid a little more.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Want to listen to your favorite GCN hosts and programs without a radio signal or internet? Just call 605-562-4213. Get instant access to all GCN live feeds right on your phone, anywhere you want, anytime you want. 605-562-4213. It's our way of ensuring everyone has the opportunity to enjoy GCN. 605-562-4213. The future of talk radio. GCN.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
CopBlock has quickly become the top police accountability group in the United States, and maybe even the world. With chapters across the globe, there's probably a group near you that you can join. If not, you can start your own. Besides joining a local CopBlock group, you can also give just $1 a month to the CopBlock network. Your contribution helps support the efforts of those who make CopBlock possible. So please join the CopBlock network now at copblock.lrn.fm. That's copblock.lrn.fm.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the radio waves to bring up whatever's on your mind. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. You can Skype in here to the show. Username is lrn.fm. And joining you in the studio tonight, it's me, Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
Conan is here courtesy of his show, which is a TV show, first and foremost, though there is an audio track version available via podcast. It is Black Sheep Rising.
Thank you, thank you. Yes, it's also regular YouTube channel. You can watch the entirety. You can see our pretty smiling faces. You can see Shauna, who just made some wonderful salsa for us.
And yeah, my nose is actually running a little bit.
I can see my two co-hosts here dripping sweat.
It is not called salsa for no reason at all.
Yeah, there's four habaneros went into that mix. But yeah, she was on last night.
Guys did just record last night then.
Right. Okay. So Joe was on and Rapture. And so we had a good little chat about some of the local politics here in Keene, among other things. We talked about Porkfest corporates and how, you know, the Porkfest is turning more and more into, I don't know, kind of a country club kind of an event where, and the rules are always different. So, I mean, from year to year, I mean, if you're going to go rent a campsite, mm-hmm. for example, Agoura Valley this year, the rules were different. So you had to pay a little more if you were a first year vendor or if you were vending food. And I think it kind of, as far as I was concerned, it kind of prevented me from wanting to go in there. We talked about it for a good 30 minutes. So mm-hmm. if you want to catch that, be looking for that this week, blacksheeprising.org.
Well, Porkfest was down in its attendees this year, down from about 1,500 to 1,300. Mm-hmm. So maybe some of those changes didn't resonate well with everybody.
Well, I was one of them, and I'm not going to go out to Porkfest and listen to all the events. because, you know, I hear these things all the time.
Sure.
I'm not going to go out there and party for 6 days straight. I'm going to go out there and I'm going to sell food, or I'm going to try to make money. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, I'm not going. And I really didn't see that I wanted to put any energy into this because I had things to do at the house.
Yeah, it might be worth putting something out there to the organizers, giving a little feedback as to why you did not sign up this year.
Well, that's the problem. The organizers seem to change every year. It's a whole different ball game, and it's like they're starting from scratch every time.
Well, if that's frustrating to you, then come to Keenvention, because at Keenvention... I'm still in charge of the event, and that has not changed.
You can get a whole different form of frustration if you come to Keenvention.
What's that, Mark?
I don't know. So Ian's
I haven't
in charge.
Heard any feedback like
we
that.
We have a Halloween party.
No, I haven't heard anything bad about Keenvention yet. But Porkfest, the reason that people are all fluffed up about Porkfest is because it is an incredibly large, popular event.
Yeah, Keenvention is very small in comparison.
Yeah.
But if you want to vend at Keenvention, basically you just kind of show up and set your stuff up on a table. Like, I don't really have any charge. I don't really charge anybody.
As long as there's room for you.
Yeah.
Maybe one day when there's standing room only, you might have to start laying down some kind of rule.
Yeah, I expect that could be the case. So anyway, keenvention.info. In fact, the Keenvention website, I just updated it last night. The Halloween party is official. It's going to happen again this year with something we did for the first time last year. It's kind of an experiment. Basically, it's a costume party, a costume dance party, sort of in the same vein as Buzz's Big Gay Dance Party, but during Halloween, so we call it Halloween, and it was a lot of fun last year. We're bringing it back. We've got a new venue. I'm not going to say where the new venue is, but it is going to be somewhere outside of the hotel, and that means we'll have more freedom to actually have food that is good. I mean, the hotel kitchen pizza was kind of crappy last year. And, you know, when you're at a hotel, they make you use their facilities. You can't call Domino's up and bring in pizzas from somewhere else.
Oh, really?
Yeah, no, that's part of the...
Oh, know what? You couldn't get Halloween on the night that you wanted either, because it coincided with another Halloween party.
That's right. That was happening in the hotel's bar. And the hotel bar didn't want us competing with their party, even though they'd be selling alcohol to the same... It was weird. So a lot of the restrictions that had affected the first Halloween are not in place. In fact, we'll be able to go later. So the first Halloween ended at midnight. This year, it's going to end at 1:30. So we're going to get an extra 90 minutes past the witching hour. And it's actually going to happen just by circumstance. It's going to happen to fall on Halloween night this year. So really, it's going to be a great event. At least I'm expecting it to be. We're actually going to get to use the fog machine this year. Last year, we were concerned. The hotel was concerned about... like possibly setting off the fire alarms, and that, of course, would be a bad thing. So, I mean, just all in all, it's going to be a better event. And, of course, Keenvention, you actually threw a bonfire during Keenvention last year.
Big one.
I don't want to put you on the spot, Conan, but are you considering doing it again?
If weather permits.
Okay, all right, excellent.
I don't want 80 people in my house if it's raining outside. If we can get them outside in the yard, then I think I can handle another one.
It was great. So go to keenvention.info. In fact, if you want to get the early bird discount ticket price of $50 for the entire weekend, that's a full convention that includes the Halloween dance party as well. So you get the full Keenvention experience for $50. The price goes up tomorrow. So if you go to keenvention.info right now, you can go and lock in your tickets for $50 or Bitcoin equivalent. So once again, keenvention.info. We'll look forward to seeing you there at the end of October. It's October 30th through November 1st. Let's continue with your calls and thoughts. We've been talking about banking, the Greece situation that is developing and just getting worse. I'll tell you what's happening to businesses in Greece right now. These restrictions that have been put on people's bank accounts are really hurting business people in Greece. We'll explain that here in a moment. But we actually had Libertarian Banker on the line a moment ago talking about fractional reserve banking, kind of coming to its defense, giving different examples of things that were similar to fractional reserve banking. And
I think he made a fantastic point about CDs. So I made
the certificate of deposit.
Yeah, here's what the point I made is that a certificate of a deposit is a much more above board situation in dealing with a bank. So if I give a bank
$5,000 for 3 years with the expectation for a certificate of deposit. And my expectation is I'll get 1.75% interest or whatever it might be. I think that's about right these days. I don't know. I don't really do CDs. But, you know, then I know what's going on. They're taking my money. They're using it for that period of time. They're going to give me a higher rate of interest, and then they'll give it back.
They lock you away from it for that period of time because they're using it. Right?
His point is that, look, if you want to get it early, and I said that, you know, I said that in my explanation, if you want to get it early, then there would be some kind of, you know, fee or whatever involved. Well, there's a fee involved in taking a loan, too, right? So whatever that fee is maybe that's exactly how they handle the certificate of deposit. So, you know, I've got a CD, you've got a CD, and Conan's got a CD. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I decide I need my money. You know, there's been a car wreck, and I need my money.
Yep.
And so I take my money back. Now,
and
I know
you forfeit your interest, basically.
I know there's going to be a penalty.
Right.
Well, whatever it is, however the bank decides to work it out, this is how the free market works. But they'll take your money to pay it off. Well, that's what a loan is. If I came to the bank and said, I don't have any money, so I'm going to take a loan, you know, then they'd charge me some interest. Well, maybe they'd be a little nicer because I have a CD with them that I put up as collateral, but that's essentially what's going on. They're taking money and they're giving it away. So, you know, it's still, they're managing loans.
With the CD, you know. That's what's happening. When you're just depositing in your bank account, you're not given that information. You're not necessarily told, oh, by the way, we're only going to keep a fraction of the money that people deposit here. Fractional reserve banking isn't exactly, you know, advertised on the front billboard.
No, I don't think anybody knows. Most people, like 90s,
they don't know about it.
90-something percent of people do not understand what fractional reserve banking
is. They'd go back to bartering eggs if they knew what was really, you know, taking place. Yeah, a lot of people don't know.
So you can share your thoughts here. We're going to go and continue with your phone calls. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I think we have Steve on the line in Minnesota. Steve, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Conan, and Mark.
Hey, guys.
Hi, Steve.
It's good to talk to you. I'm a longtime amper. You're the best thing on the internet, best podcast out there, best thing on the airwaves.
Aw, thank
really
you. What do you want to share tonight?
What you guys are doing. Well, you know, I listened to the podcast earlier today from last night, and I heard a caller call in. His name was Dave, and he was calling about wanting to fly his Confederate flag at Pork Fest. And,
he did.
And and that somebody had told him that that wasn't a good idea and that he was kind of upset about that.
Well, just to be clear, he did fly his Confederate flag at Pork Fest. He was told not to fly it during the group photo.
Right.
So he himself put it, I think, probably on his campsite. I know he was tooling around the campground in an ATV flying the flag from that. So no one restricted his expression in that way. That he was just asked to not fly it during the group photo because it might possibly suggest to people looking at the photo that maybe there's a bunch of racists in that picture. And I can understand that.
Yeah, I can totally understand that, too. I totally agree with the organizers that they should have discouraged that or stopped it altogether. Mm-hmm. You know, because it's pretty likely that such a picture could, you know, there's a lot of people that might misunderstand Dave.
Exactly.
Sure. That's the problem with symbols, right? Like, the flag is a symbol, and it's a symbol of a lot of different things to a lot of different people, specifically the stars and bars.
Steve, if you had more to say, you can hang on. We will bring you back here after the news.
Yep.
855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. More on what's happening in Greece. Business owners are in a real tough spot because of these banking, lockdowns. We'll explain more coming up.
Hi, my name's Cody, and I want to tell you about Peacekeeper. Peacekeeper is the world's first decentralized peer-to-peer protection system. We are developing a smartphone app that revolutionizes how people protect one another. Peacekeeper is a disruptive alternative to the status quo.
Peacekeeper is a leap forward in protection services, allowing neighbors to respond far more quickly than police and fire services can. And this is a real community builder, too.
Visit peacekeeper.org and join us.
What are you doing?
Looking for the best hotel value in America.
That's easy. It's America's Best Value Inn.
Really?
Sure. They have over 1,000 hotels across North America.
Okay, that's good.
They offer free Wi-Fi, continental breakfast, and HBO at most locations.
That's even better.
And when you join their free value club, you get 15% off, room upgrade, and late checkout when available.
You're right. America's Best Value Inn is the best hotel value in America.
Book a room today at abvi.com.
Done.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, June 30th, 2015. Silver is trading up $15.72 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,172 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $264. Antiwar.com reports weekend reports of a planned Turkish invasion of Syria, aimed primarily at attacking Kurdish forces there, are now being denied by officials who say they instead will be building up security along the border in areas the Kurds control. The rhetoric generally continues, however, with one Turkish newspaper declaring the Kurds in Syria more dangerous than the Islamic State, and officials very publicly taking the U.S. to task for its growing aid to the Kurdish YPG inside Syria, seeing it as a threat to Turkey's border. Turkey's policy in the Syrian civil war has been informed almost entirely by its desire to weaken Kurdish secessionist movements there. So far, however, that has left the Turkish border with the Islamic State, Al-Qaeda, and a large Kurdish autonomous region where Syria once was. And while the U.S. and Turkey's other regional allies see the Islamic State as the biggest problem right now, Turkey clearly views the Kurds as the biggest deal, and with the U.S. backing those Kurds in hopes of weakening the Islamic State, they are effectively making the YPG an even stronger faction. Turkey has gotten itself into another corner with this policy, however, as while they try to sell a buffer zone carved out of Syrian Kurdistan for refugees, the reality is it will weaken the Kurds and, by extension, take the pressure off the Islamic State, meaning Turkey will almost certainly be alone in supporting this policy.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports police in Vicksburg, Mississippi arrested two people after a team of ghost hunters discovered the body of a woman Sunday at the abandoned Coon Memorial State Hospital, reputed to be one of the state's most haunted sites. The group found the body of 69-year-old Sharon Wilson lying outside the old hospital, though police said blood trails indicate that she was inside the building at one point and appeared to have head trauma. David Childers, co-founder of the Mississippi Paranormal Research Institute, was not among the ghost hunters who discovered Wilson's body. Police Chief Walter Armstrong told WAPT-TV in Jackson that Raphael McLeod and his nephew Akeem McLeod were arrested and faced charges related to the woman's death. Police said the McLeods confessed to breaking into Wilson's home, kidnapping and robbing her, but they said that they left her on the side of the road. The two had been arrested after they were pulled over for reckless driving and were discovered to be allegedly driving Wilson's vehicle.
In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com.
Reuters reports the U.S. Supreme Court on Monday found that a lethal injection drug used by Oklahoma does not violate the U.S. Constitution's ban on cruel and unusual punishment, a ruling that provoked a caustic debate among the justices about the death penalty in the U.S. The 5-4 ruling prompted Stephen Breyer and Ruth Bader Ginsburg to say for the first time they believe that capital punishment, as currently practiced, may be unconstitutional. They are the only members of the court to have expressed such views. The decision was a defeat for death penalty foes and for the three death row inmates who challenged the use of a sedative called midazolam as part of Oklahoma's lethal injection process, saying it cannot achieve the level of unconsciousness required for surgery, making it unsuitable for executions. Justice Samuel Alito, writing on behalf of the court, said that the inmates had failed to demonstrate that any risk of harm was substantial when compared to a known and available alternative method of execution. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The push to legalize marijuana is gaining momentum. These prescription doobies will do a whole lot more than just give patients a case of the munchies. Proponents are piping up to say that medical marijuana can help patients with some of the chronic illnesses that have been majorly killing their buzz. Unfortunately, 36 U.S. states are still not a kind bud of the legalization argument. But in states that do have the plan, the results have been, well, pretty far out, man. Patients nationwide are bluntly asking state legislatures to finally mellow out so that they and their doctors can work jointly to stop the suffering that's making a hash of their lives.
So it's clearly an issue that means a lot to these patients.
So states shouldn't toke their time with this policy. We'd be upset if patients had to wait a long time.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, dial toll free to join us here and bring up anything that you want to discuss at 855-450-FREE. We're talking about Greece and what's going on over there. It's a dire situation that's only getting worse. I actually haven't even really given you the update on what the latest is. We've been talking about how Bitcoin has been exploding in popularity compared to the normal amount of interest in Greece. It's been shooting up. And that's where we started, but it took us to a larger conversation about fractional reserve banking. And by the way, with you in studio, you've got me, Ian, tonight.
And Conan.
And Mark.
And we're going to go right back into your calls and thoughts and then more about what's happening over in Greece. First, let's go back to Steve in Minnesota. Steve, you were commenting on the situation regarding the guy who called last night to sort of explain his viewpoint on the Confederate flag and why he is flying it and was flying it at the Porcupine Freedom Festival. The guy who was asked to not fly that very same flag in the picture, the group photo of the Porcupine Freedom Festival, which he did accede to those requests and did not fly it during that photo. So that's a good thing. But anyway, go ahead with your thoughts, Steve.
Yeah, I just wanted to say, you know, I totally agree with the organizers not wanting that in the picture. It makes perfect sense to me for obvious reasons. But I did want to say that, you know, Dave had a hard time articulating how he felt about that and why that seemed important to him. And I thought about it a little bit. And I thought maybe I could articulate it, you know, maybe a little better. And I thought I'd take a shot at it if you give me a chance.
Okay.
And I think, you know, here's, at least in my mind, I see, you know, some pretty powerful, influential people in academia, the media, government. They've been targeting our language for a long time and they've been changing it. You know, there's a kind of this radical leftist, Saul Alinsky, who said, "He who controls the language controls the masses." Right? And symbols mean things, right? They have traditional meanings, and when traditional symbols are under attack, certain things come under attack. So, you know, I'm 46 years old, grew up in Minnesota, I'm not from the South, but, you know, to us up here, the Confederate flag, or at least that symbol, when I was growing up, when I was a teenager and stuff, it just really meant one thing. It just meant rebellion. That's it. You know, It meant things like motorcycles and Leonard Skinner music and drinking whiskey and giving the middle finger to authority, right? I mean, that's all it was about.
Yeah.
And, you know, I mean, I even saw, you know, at a Guns N' Roses concert back in 92 that Axl Rose, you know, he's wearing his rebel flag jacket. I mean, that's what we called it. We called it the rebel flag. And so, You know, there's a few labels that if they stick, they're going to make you a social pariah. And one of those labels is racist, you know, and then there's pedophile, there's rapist, there's those sorts of things. So if you can associate those labels with symbols, ideas, words, you can start to control the debate and control people and control the imagery, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, these words like racist and stuff like that, they've even evolved into like having huge umbrellas that mean things they didn't even mean in the past. Like today, I think you can kind of be a racist without even knowing it by accident through things they call microaggressions and things like that. And they can, you can just get labeled these things, you know, well back then,
because it's easier to label somebody than it is to have a conversation with them. Right. And but, like,
well, that's absolutely true. And I think what he was getting at is that, you know, they're going after a symbol that doesn't necessarily represent that to everyone. And he's kind of latched onto that. You know, if you attack, well, it kind of happened to Ron Paul, right? Do you remember the 2008 election? So when an image of rebellion comes out and it's effective and it's viral and it's really working, it won't be long before somebody tries to attach misogyny or racism mm-hmm. to that. And that happened to Ron Paul in 2008. Do you guys remember that?
Oh, yeah. I remember they had some old Ron Paul newsletters from like the 1980s that had some racist stuff in them.
Racist sounding.
It was even more than that, though. It was more than that. There were some people online. There were some websites that were racist websites that were endorsing him. And they were trying to tie him together with all of that nonsense.
Right. So every candidate
movement,
this is sort of really important because it's just happened to Rand Paul recently too, is that basically you know, nobody cares who the KKK is giving money to unless it's to a libertarian. So I don't know which candidates you know, I have no clue. Really. Have no clue which candidates are you know, the KKK is giving money to, but I can tell you that it wouldn't surprise me at all if it's a bunch of Republicans and maybe some Democrats, but nobody ever says, George Bush or, Mitt Romney or whoever got money from the KKK. They only say it if their last name ends with Paul.
That's right. I mean, and they will do it to just about anybody to try and discredit them.
Steve, thanks for your call tonight, man. I do appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Yeah, I mean, I think he's pointing out something that seems based on, you know, observations of what happens. I think that's probably the case. You really can't really be too concerned about it in advance. You just sort of have to deal with it when it comes up. And if you're not a racist, then it shouldn't be a problem, right?
Now, but as far as the symbols are concerned, is this a worthwhile battle to keep trying to – I mean, we know, you know, that the – well, the Confederate flag doesn't stand for slavery.
It doesn't,
There were some slaveholders who, you know, flew the flag above their plantations during the days, and there are KKKs that run around waving their Confederate flags. But that's not what it meant. Just like the caller said, it was a rebellious flag. It was rebelling against the North.
Sure, but you're not going to fly it from the back of your truck anytime.
But I mean,
soon,
how
right?
Is this a fight that we should spend any time trying to win?
Absolutely.
I mean,
there's,
the majority have decided that this is what the flag represents. So, in the same thing with the Nazi symbol,
yep.
You know, even though that's it wasn't isn't that like a Hindu?
It's like an old Indian symbol.
It's like an Indian,
right?
Peace sign or something.
Yep. Well, that's
the swastika.
The swastika is going the other direction. So, I asked my wife after this incident what she thought of the rebel flag when she saw it. Now, she's from Illinois.
At Porkfest, you mean the Porcupine?
Just
Freedom
generally.
Festival? Oh, general. Okay.
What does the rebel flag mean to you? Because this is important. It's a symbol, and it means different things to different people.
Yes.
And basically, you know, she had a bunch of things to say, and none of them were positive, right? Like, so, you know, country, redneck, dumb, racist. Like, these words were coming out. Now, I am from the South. I'm from Florida, and perhaps there's, you know, Sarasota, Florida. Perhaps there's something more deep South than where I'm from. But
there,
to me,
it definitely is. Yes,
I have a certain positive feeling about the rebel flag.
I think Daryl comes from that place. It's
yep.
deeper South than we are, even though
it's more North.
Even though we hang lower on the testicle of the United States.
Right.
But you know, everybody's got their opinion. For me, what it means is sort of, hey, we're Southern and we're fine with being Southern. If you don't like that we're Southern, go F yourself, right? Like, here, Yankee, have a whole bunch of go F yourself. Like, that's what it means to me. And, you know, I mean, like,
from the standpoint, and it also means sort of from I think many other Southerners, it means, you know, if we did this this war again, this time we'd kick your ass, right? Mm-hmm. Like, it means
South
that
will rise again,
right? It means a lot of that, and that doesn't have anything. None of that has anything to do with color, yep. From the standpoint. When I look at the rebel flag. You know, now it's getting more difficult because there's all this this baggage attached to it. But when at one point in my life, when I looked at the rebel flag, I didn't think to myself, yes, they hate black people just like me. Like, that's nothing like that is going on. So,
You're not saying you hate black people.
I am not saying that. That what I'm saying is that this is the kind of nonsense that's attached to it. Mm-hmm. And you can have whatever opinion you want to have about it, but just understand that symbols are symbols and they mean different things to different people.
Yep.
I do not think that a flag of a defeated nation should be flying out in front of the state house of a capital that is part of the United States. Look, if you want to be part of the United States, then be part of the United States. Don't fly this this flag in front of the state house. I'm not for that. I just don't think that makes sense. But the individuals that have it, that's their business.
Our toll-free number tonight, if you want to join this discussion or whatever you want to talk about, you can do that here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Any other thoughts, Conan, on the Confederate flag?
Well, I mean, I have an anarchy flag in my house. It's hanging right next to a peace flag, the same one you got hanging off the CAC, the one that keeps getting taken. And there are some negative feelings of that flag, a red anarchy symbol on a black field. I mean, people see that and they think that I'm apt to throw a bottle through their window or, you know, run over their cat or, you know, whatever. And, you know, but it's not at the level the Confederate flag is this week.
If it's red, I just think you're a communist.
We'll come back with more here in moments. Conan's with us from blacksheeprising.org. We'll continue with your calls or welcome about anything, plus more about Greece coming up.
Discover how deep your American roots go for free this 4th of July weekend. Go to TryAncestry.com to get free access through July 5th. Visit TryAncestry.com anytime this Wednesday through Sunday, and you'll have free access to our collection of records from the original 13 colonies and with a new visual story experience. Celebrate this 4th of July and take advantage of this free access weekend. Visit TryAncestry.com. That's TryAncestry.com. TryAncestry.com.
Every summer we go to Canyon Woods. Love getting outside. Love the hiking. Hate the itching and irritation from poison ivy, bug bites, all the things that keep me inside. So I need something strong.
Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing is clinically proven with the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief of itching and irritation with 7 moisturizers to help heal skin.
I finally have the relief I need.
Hey, Jan, check this out.
On my way.
Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
6 drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live, toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. You can Skype into the show here. The Skype username is lrn.fm, so feel free to reach out to us in that way if you like. With you in studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
If you're online at all, whether it's on your cell phone, your laptop, or your desktop computer at home or at work, you should be protecting yourself with ProXPN. It's a global virtual private network. It's software you can download for free right now. For Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux, you go to proxpn.com/FTL, grab ProXPN software, get it up and running, it only takes a moment, and they will encrypt your internet connection. That encryption protects you from prying and spying, say by your internet service provider who might be logging every website you visit, maybe logging all the search terms that you're entering as well, selling that data perhaps to other companies, maybe turning it over to the government. You can stop that from happening with ProXPN. Plus, with their premium account, you also get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. ProXPN is a super handy tool, and it's also super affordable. When you use our code, I mean, it's already affordable without our code, but when you use our code FTL50, you'll save 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy the annual account with code FTL50. Over at proxpn.com/FTL. And again, save 50% with code FTL50. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. So go to proxpn.com/FTL, and don't forget code FTL50 for a great discount on privacy that is priceless. All right, toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. We're going to go right back into your calls and thoughts. Next up, we have Tyler on the line in Washington State. Tyler, you're on Free Talk Live.
Guys, how's it going?
Welcome, Tyler. Go ahead.
So, you guys were talking about the Confederate flag ordeal just a second ago, and I wanted to touch on that because I noticed, Ian, you said that generally the libertarians are kind of pushing this issue out of the way, saying that this isn't a battle we're willing to fight. But I kind of feel like there is an underlying issue that we're missing here. And part of it is that with the Confederate flag, you can't really compare it to the Nazi, swastika, because, that's universally hated by American society. We all agree that, the Nazis were wrong. A few people, obviously fringe people are going to disagree with that. But with the Confederate flag, you kind of saw a 50-50 where, some people like Mark, and I kind of agree with Mark on this one, it was a symbol of rebellion, and it was a battle flag, not a national flag. It was, what the troops carried in the battle, and so people can see that as something to take pride in because the South fought, a really hard war.
It's the ultimate secessionist flag, the secession flag.
Well, yeah, and that's true. I mean, like, they were kind of saying, hey, we don't want to be part of your society anymore. We think you're wrong. We're going to leave. And then, the Fed said, well, hold on now. We need your tax money. You're going to stick around a little bit longer. And then you have the other side that sees it as, oppressionist, which, I don't think either side is right or wrong, but it's really just, your opinion on the flag. But what we have today is we have this like Victorian-era moral policing that's going on where people are getting online and there's this giant outcry and they're fighting back and forth. And then the government decides that they're going to get involved and start telling us their opinion. And then whoever the government sides with, people think, oh, well, hey, we've won because if the government thinks it's right, then our side must be the right side. And then it just kind of turns the other side into these criminals who are ignorant from the start, which, you know, creates an animosity. It creates this divide between society, you know, and it just kind of it's a form of censorship by majority rules, I think. What are your guys' thoughts on that?
Well, it's not censorship. I mean, no one has stopped anyone from buying a Confederate flag and waving it from behind their pickup truck. So that hasn't been stopped. Just because some people at a private event requested that somebody not have the Confederate flag in a group photo.
He's talking about the issue generally, not specifically.
Okay. Well, I don't see any censorship happening by the government with the Confederate flag.
No, I don't think so. He said basically by the majority rules censorship. And
that's not censorship. Censorship is where there's somebody who's in charge of something who says you can't see this.
Right. I think this is another loss for the Confederacy is what this is. The Confederacy has now lost the war to display the flag too, and it's over. Like from what I can tell, at this point when you the people that want to keep it are the ones are the sort of folks that can easily be vilified, right? Like males and people who are ethnically privileged and people who make a living wage
and dudes who rev their trucks too high.
So from this point on, anyone who waves the flag is automatically going to be labeled a racist. So yeah, it may not necessarily be censorship, but, we're not all the type of people who are always willing to stand up, even though everybody around us is booing us. More power to you if you are. That's great character. But I feel like a lot of people are going to be silenced because of this. Now, it's not direct censorship, obviously. No one's saying you can't wave the flag. But they have turned it into a very ugly symbol where before, it was kind of tolerated by one side, even though they may not have necessarily agreed with it. And this is just going to lead to bigger issues. Like, for a good example is, like, so with the gay pride flag, I think the gay marriage being legalized was a huge win for civil rights. But a lot of the hyper-religious can go out now and say, oh, well, that flag offends me because it represents perversion in our society, et cetera, and it's just going to turn into another, social justice warrior fight between, the right and the left and create an even bigger divide. So I think, like, one of the things that, libertarians as a group need to point out is we can't just let the Confederate flag slip to the side because it may have a negative connotation. We should show, like, hey, by the way, even though some people see it as a negative connotation or have a negative connotation on it, we should also look at the fact that these people shouldn't be persecuted just because they want to exercise their freedom of speech.
Well, that's what I've tried to do here by talking about the different things that the flag symbolizes. What I'm attempting to do is to sort of create bridges between people because although I think that the Confederate flag is the most attractive of flags, and which is to say I'm not a big fan of flags generally, but I like it. I just like the way it looks, and to me it doesn't represent anything particularly bad when I was growing up or anything like that. It just sort of meant where you were from and sort of rebellion and those sorts of things.
Right.
So that's what I see. But other people see different things. Like, I can understand why some black person may say, I don't really want to be friends with that guy that's flying the rebel flag from the back of his pickup truck.
Well, nobody's being persecuted for flying. You use the word persecuted, Tyler, and nobody's been persecuted for it that I know of. They're just people that are coming to conclusions quietly, usually.
I think that is coming. I mean, you're being persecuted for flying a peace flag in your house, on the side of your house. It's being stolen.
I'm
every
not.
Sure
That's
you
the,
are.
They're stealing the peace flag because
someone
we're activists.
Dump a bucket. Well, okay, that as well, but. Or
because it's fun to steal things. That's what teenagers
could you
do.
Imagine if you did have a Confederate flag outside of your house?
Well, I wouldn't do that.
But this is the argument about the Confederate flag now. What's it going to be in a year? You might get a bottle thrown through
It'll
your pickup
over
truck
in a year. I mean, look, this is only an issue because somebody went up and like stole or shot at a flag in South Carolina on state property or something like that. That's the only reason why this has even come forth, as bubbled up as any kind of controversy. The Confederate flag has been flown long before and will continue to fly long after this particular controversy bubbles over. Hey, thanks, Tyler, for your call tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You know, I'm not going to fly the Confederate flag because I know what people think about it, and I'm not a particular fan of it myself anyway. But peace flags, I like that. Apparently some people don't like them. They like to steal them. That's their problem, not mine. 855-450-FREE.
We love that you're passionate about GCN. And whether you're a listener, a business owner, or a radio industry professional, we've redesigned the new GCN newsletter to keep you in the know. Get updates on your favorite GCN shows and hosts. Go to GCNlive.com and click on the banner in the upper left corner. Just for signing up, you're automatically entered for monthly giveaways. Start receiving your newsletter today. The future of talk radio. GCN.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Hi, I'm Montel Williams. Most of you know me as a talk show host, but I'm also an author, actor, single father of four, a fitness writer, avid snowboarder, and I'm also a medical marijuana patient. Like many of the million people who are living with multiple sclerosis, I'm in pain every single day. And sometimes my nerves are so raw that if you brushed up against me in an elevator, I'd scream. I can't sleep at night from the pain, and sometimes the spasms in my legs are so intense they will wake me up throughout the night. I've tried the strongest prescription medications available, and I'm going to tell you, they do not work. In fact, they leave me in a stupor, and most of the time, it's impossible to even live your life. Now, I've tried medical marijuana, and I'm going to tell you something, it works. If you'd like more information about medical marijuana, you can contact the Marijuana Policy Project at MPP.org or call 1-877-JOIN-MPP.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
We're back now with more Free Talk Live here at 855-450-FREE. You can join us via Skype as well at Skype username lrn.fm. So feel free to reach out in the way that is best for you. With you in studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Conan.
And King Mark the First.
Oh, yeah.
All right. And I want to also invite you to check out Purse. We've talked about Purse before they came on as a sponsor of the program, which is a good indicator that I'm a big fan of this particular product. This, you know, whatever it is I'm saying about Purse, they're definitely not paying me to say here. I'm a big fan. It was before they came on board. And I love it. I mean, I use it every time I need something on Amazon. Every time I can wait for something on Amazon. And even if you don't want to wait, they have Purse Instant. And you can still get a discount. I think it's like 5 or 8% or something like that. I've actually never used Purse Instant because I want to get 20% off or more on everything. And so I'm willing to wait. In the case of the most recent thing I put on Purse, it was a router for the studio here. I put it on there, put it to a 20% discount, and it went in 90 minutes. Somebody made the purchase of that product for me in less than 90 minutes. So you don't have to wait.
What rate?
At what rate? 20% off.
20%. Yeah.
So you don't have to wait very long to have somebody snap up your offer over on Purse. And basically what's happening is you're putting whatever it is you want from Amazon on your wish list at Amazon. You then copy your wish list URL into Purse, and it sort of ingests the items that are on the wish list. They then give you a little sliding scale. You can slide up to how much percentage you want off of that item. And then you deposit your Bitcoin into Purse, and then basically Purse puts your Bitcoin into a marketplace of buyers who are willing to pay quite a premium in order to get that Bitcoin sort of without having to go through the typical financial channels. They can use their credit card, for instance, to get Bitcoin. So there are people who want to get Bitcoin, and they will buy your Bitcoin at 20% above cost, essentially.
I've noticed that anytime I ever shop online and I'm going to use Bitcoin, I'm always looking for some discount button.
This is it.
Because these people really do save money doing their transactions in Bitcoin. I mean, if you can cancel out the banks and the credit card companies, you have those fees that you're saving. And Bitcoin is instantaneous. The only thing you have to worry about is, you know, maybe transaction fees with the bank, if you're, say, using something like Coinbase or something. But other than that, once it's in the system, and it's good.
Yep. And so you can save up to 25% off or more on Purse by going through purse.freetalklive.com. Get signed up through our URL, and Free Talk Live will get a very small percentage of each of your purchases from that point forward through Purse. So purse.freetalklive.com. This is a killer app for Bitcoin. You were looking for an excuse to spend your Bitcoin? Well, how about getting 20 to 25 to more percentage off on whatever you want to buy from Amazon's inventory. Once again, that's purse.freetalklive.com. I'm a huge fan of what they're doing over there. So let's go back to a Bitcoin, unless we had more. Do you guys have more on the Confederate flag that you wanted to say, gentlemen?
I'm saying it's not that big of a fight. You know, go ahead and move on. Adopt the new flag. Go with your black and yellow voluntarist flag, or your Gadsden flag, or your anarchy flag, but just because they don't have the baggage associated with them yet. Because, you know, one day if they ever become big enough, you know, it just like all things will come to an end. You know, once they become popular enough, and you'll be demonized by the enemy.
We'll talk more about Greece coming up. Mark's on the line in North Carolina. Let's go to the phones to the fun. Mark, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian Conan and another Mark.
Hey. Hey, how are you doing?
Good, sir. Go ahead with your thoughts, please.
Okay, well, my thoughts are really simple. First of all of this demonization is mostly fictitious and made up by the left. There are a lot of things that they're passing off as fact that aren't even remotely close to true, so I pretty much tend to ignore it. But I wanted to say that for me and a lot of other people I know, there's only one thing that Confederate flag symbolizes for me, and that's Daisy Duke wearing them tight shorts.
Oh, yeah.
Boom. That's cute.
How is that offensive to anybody?
Oh, I think that a lot of people have made the caveat that as long as the Confederate flag is on top of a 69 Charger, it's okay, which is funny, and it derails the conversation into something that pretty much everybody can agree on, which is the General Lee was one badass car.
Yeah, and here's one other thing to think about, too. While Amazon and Walmart and all these other places have pulled all merchandise Confederate off of their shelves and available for purchase, I find it ironic that you can, on Amazon and eBay and even Walmart online, still get a Nazi flag, an ISIS flag. You can buy all of these other flags.
Che Guevara, Mao.
Yeah, All of this stuff that they're doing is a distraction. The left is using this particular thing as a distraction from one thing. And this is just my personal opinion from Hillary Clinton. They're trying to do anything they can to distract from Hillary Clinton. And, hey, this is as good a topic as any.
I do not see a Nazi flag, at least the legit swastika flag, on Amazon. There are some things that are darn close that have You saw it yesterday? Well, it's not showing up on my feed. You can, however, get a USSR flag and a Japanese battle flag and a variety of other things there. I do see a Confederate something or other here, so I don't know.
I highly doubt that Amazon is involved in a conspiracy theory to distract people from the Hillary Clinton campaign.
No. I don't believe they are. They're in things for profit. And yeah. If they get the wind that selling something is going to cost them business, they'll stop it. I don't believe for one minute that they're part of a conspiracy. They're just reacting as a profit-based business, and I have no problem
sure.
with that.
Also, I don't see any ISIS flags on Amazon either. I don't see those.
Yesterday, you could get one.
Well, they must have just taken it off, because I just did a search for
ISIS
flags.
They must have done a purging.
Here's a book, The Swastika Symbol Beyond Redemption.
Hey, thanks for the call, man. I appreciate your thoughts.
Thanks.
I appreciate you sharing them with us here tonight. 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Ron. He is also listening. I forgot to mention Mark was in Raleigh listening to Talk Radio 850, as is Ron. Ron, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Conan, and Mark.
Hey, you guys, I just want to say be careful surfing around the web looking for an ISIS flag. I mean, Big Brother's probably been watching.
We're already on their list, man. All three of us.
Well, that's a good point, though. I mean, he's pointing out that the federal government's awfully touchy about anything that could be considered supporting ISIS.
And I don't have my ProXPN running right now, actually. I had turned it off earlier for another purpose, and whoops.
All right. Well, just a couple points. I mean, this is better than the long discussion you had about comtrails. I mean, it is kind of getting stale, I guess, about this flag, but a couple of points I want to make. First of all is you used the term stars and bars. That flag that has been banned, that has so been demonized, is not even the stars and bars. That's actually the battle flag for the Confederacy.
So they don't call the Second Virginia battle flag, they don't call that the stars and bars?
The stars and bars has actually got three wide stripes. I believe it's two red and one white, and then it has a blue background with a circle of stars. That's the stars and bars.
That's the original flag. Confederate battle flag,
that's
right?
The one that flew. That's the one that flew over the Confederate White House, and that was confused in the early battles, I guess, with the smoke and whatnot, because it kind of looked like, you know, the American flag. So they kind of had trouble with flags initially, and they came up with that the big, I think, the Southern Cross, I guess you could call it. That's the Confederate battle flag, and that's the one that's causing all the hoopla. I'm just wondering, I think, you know, one of your other guys said before that last call, is if something catches on and becomes more and more, of a symbol for more and more people, eventually people are going to get pissed off about it and banning it, like the Bonnie Blue. I happen to like that Bonnie Blue flag, but that really was the original flag before the stars and bars. That goes back to, like, I don't know, 1820 or 1830, when the Western Florida, along with some of the southern states in that area, English-speaking people were going up against the Spanish at that time. And ultimately, a symbol means something.
The Bonnie Blue is just a blue flag with a white star in it?
Yeah, it's a lone star. They actually, Texas used it when they were fighting against the Mexicans for their independence.
Yeah.
But it was also adopted by the Confederate States.
It's a very sovereign symbol right there.
Yeah, I mean,
thanks for clearing it up, Ron. I appreciate the info, and thank you for the call tonight.
Stars represent the state, and so like a big fat star in the middle of it is like a big fat middle finger to me. I'm just not that interested in it. But it's elegant.
855-450-FREE. That's our toll-free number. You can join us here with your thoughts on whatever you want. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up on Greece.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius, zog.ninja, code FTL.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
We've been patiently waiting. Waiting while you tried to ignore us. Waiting while you acted like we didn't exist. Waiting for our chance to be taken seriously. The wait is over. GCN is available 24/7 at GCNlive.com. Navigate through news from your favorite hosts and download archives of past shows. Download the app on your smartphone or tablet or visit GCNlive.com for instant access and live streaming. GCNlive.com. The future of talk radio. Now at your fingertips.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Back now with more Free Talk Live. If you would like to join us, you can here, 855-450-FREE. You know, I happen to agree with one of our last callers that I think this is this Confederate flag topic's pretty stale, but obviously other people don't think that. They've been calling about it for the last several nights here on Free Talk Live. This has been a very controversial issue, even though, as far as I'm concerned, it's old and it's been resolved a long time ago. This Confederate flag is it's a dead symbol, as far as I'm concerned.
Well, flags are things that people get really whipped up about. There was a post on the Free Talk Live's Facebook page recently pointing out that if you're all upset about the Confederate flag, consider the atrocities and terrible things the United States flag has flown over.
Oh, yeah. It's flown for a lot longer, over a lot more millions of people dying.
Right. And that these symbols, and that's what they are, they're just symbols, that these symbols mean different things for different people. Try to imagine what that symbol might mean if you were just some, I don't know, person in rural Pakistan, you know, area that's children were blown up accidentally by some kind of hellfire missile. Imagine what the United States flag would mean to you. Mm-hmm. You would probably think it's a pretty bad symbol. Well,
I would agree with them.
There you go. Whereas there's plenty of people here in the United States, right or wrong, that believe that the U.S. flag stands for freedom.
They do.
And it stands for a variety of things. Okay, so I'm not going to agree or disagree with your statement as to what a flag means, because it means different things to different people. All I would warn you is that when you consider a symbol, that you try to consider what it might mean to someone else on the other side. Attempt to walk a few feet in someone else's moccasins rather than being a rigid a-hole and just thinking that your opinion is the only opinion that could possibly be right. Mm. This goes for everybody, and it goes for every flag and all the symbols. That's good advice.
I think this goes for not just for symbols, but just another person's opinion or argument in general. Just, you know, walk in their shoes, and you might figure out real quick why they don't like you or why they're defending themselves against your hellfire missiles, as you just said.
Well, I've tried, when somebody's opinion one way or another, I can look at it and parse it out. But a symbol isn't an opinion, right? So if I'm walking around,
There's the opinion about the symbol.
A former co-host, Luther, who used to be on the show at one point, he has a shirt that has the hammer and sickle on it, and it says CCCP.
Yep.
Now I have no idea what that shirt means to that guy. But I'm reasonably certain he is not
a communist
or, wants to see people thrown in gulags all around.
I think it's some punk thing.
Yeah, it's a punk thing. Yeah. It's an iconoclastic thing. It's whatever it is. And
it's ironic.
Many of the people who, have the Che Guevara shirts on, that whatever that means to them, I'm not even sure what it means to them.
I bet it's, they probably think it means rebellion or something like that, even though Che just wanted to be in charge.
Well, Che was certainly a rebel and a successful one, but he was also, but pretty terrible autocrat and a murderer.
The murderer.
There's no doubt about it. So I'm not going to hold them up and laud them as some great individual. But I do understand these are symbols, and yes, I will agree with you that some people interpret symbols incorrectly from my point of view. However, a symbol should be an opportunity to talk to somebody about what they think.
Yeah, that's true. But you don't generally get that opportunity if somebody's puttering on by with their pickup truck and the Confederate flag billowing behind it.
It's one of the reasons I would never put it on one of my vehicles, because although I think it's an extraordinarily attractive flag as far as flags go, I think it's the best looking one, maybe behind Cornwall, but I wouldn't put it on anything because it might make somebody feel bad. It might make some black person feel like I don't like them. And why would I ever want to do that?
I'm not sure how many people who are actually really into their flags could really sit down and have a deep conversation with you. If you ask them, what does that flag mean to you? Why are you flying it off the side of your house? I mean, what does it really stand for? I'm thinking they're just going to say, as far as the American flag is concerned, well, it stands for freedom. And that's it. And that's probably as far as they can really go with it. And if you try to tell them that, hey, look, how many countless battles have been fought in the name of that flag.
If you don't like it, leave.
Right, exactly.
So here's the thing from our Facebook page. It has 8.8 million views.
Whoa.
It's a huge one. I know you don't pay attention to the Facebook page much, Ian, but this is the most viewed post that we've had. Now, not versus a meme as opposed to a, it's not a post, it's a meme versus a video. So we've had videos that have had more views, but as far as a sort of a picture, an image, that's the term. It's not even a meme, it's an image. It says, it has the Confederate flag and says, had slavery 4 years. If you want to ban this flag because it represents racism, murder, and oppression, and then it goes down to the American flag, and of course has a Free Talk Live brand on it because I make sure that every one of them has that. It says, Trail of Tears, Tortures Enemies, Wars of Aggression, had slavery 89 years, 12 of its presidents owned slaves, killed over 500,000 Iraqi children, police kill over 1,000 citizens each year, killed over 100,000 civilians with nuclear weapons.
That sounds like a meme to me.
interred
Japanese.
The
memes have the text on them like that.
Yeah, a meme actually refers to sort of an idea.
Uh-huh. Something that's viral.
Yeah, right, and whatever that idea is. So I'm not entirely sure this is a meme because it's not getting used over and over again. So when you have, for instance, Grumpy Cat,
yeah,
and a picture of him going, got into a car accident, good. You know,
I
that
would
kind
say
of,
that's a meme, though, because, I mean, generally...
Grumpy Cat's a meme. This is an image, would be my contention.
Yeah, this is an image with some good text on it. But if it becomes popular enough, if, you know, enough people get behind that idea and are, you know, espouse that idea, then it does become a meme.
It's a meme, right? And yeah, you've got 8 million views. That's a meme.
I would
no,
say
no.
That's
okay,
viral.
Hold on just a second. The meme... So the Grumpy Cat thing, you can write different stuff over and over on.
Right, that's a reusable picture that you can make memes out of, right?
No, that's the meme.
No, Grumpy Cat's picture by itself is not a meme. It's not meme worthy. It's not going to spread 8 million times. But the text over top of it is what makes the meme. That's why, like, websites like Quick Meme or whatever, you can just make your own memes.
But yeah, they usually have pictures that encapsulate an idea, but Grumpy Cat is always going to have a similar topic.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas the guy with the hat, the butthole with the hat, he always has a very similar topic. Those are
Scumbag
memes.
Steve.
Scumbag Steve. Those are ideas.
I love those.
And whatever he says it's not necessarily the meme. Scumbag Steve is the meme.
Scumbag Steve is the meme. The stuff written on it then makes the image. So I'm reading here from meme, from Google's defining it, an element of culture or system of behavior that may be considered to be passed from one individual to another by non-genetic means, especially imitation. So humorous image, video, piece of text, that's the secondary one, certainly.
Right, a humorous image.
That's the secondary one. Look, I know that people call images memes, Ian. What I'm trying to do is...
Not every image is a meme.
Why not?
Only the ones that get passed around.
To how many people?
I don't know if there's no set amount of people that makes it into a meme. It's probably more than two.
No.
Would be my guess.
I disagree with your definition of a meme. A meme is an idea, especially sort of an image on the internet specifically.
An internet meme, according to Wikipedia, is an activity, concept, catchphrase, or piece of media which spreads often as mimicry from person to person.
See the mimicry part?
Via the internet.
This is what I'm talking about, is the mimicry part. So they take the Grumpy Cat picture, and then they write different things around it. And that goes from the Grumpy Cat meme to the specific image you have created. And that's all I'm saying. This is an image, it's not a meme.
And of course, this has evolved too. If you looked up this a year ago, a meme was just an idea that a lot of people are...
It's getting misused so often that in 5 years, a meme will just be an image, and you won't be able to...
A popular image that floats on social media.
That's because pretty much what a meme is, as far as I'm concerned.
Some people just can't get the idea of what a meme is, and the fact is it's an idea.
Well, right. The picture by itself without the words isn't an idea. Grumpy Cat
sitting there looking
at you is not an idea.
A picture of your cat is just a picture of your cat, but a picture of Grumpy Cat... That is a meme.
But that's not an idea.
No,
Grumpy Cat is an idea.
Right, but I think you have to sort of write something around Grumpy Cat in order to get into the meme. So I would agree that a picture of Grumpy Cat isn't a meme necessarily, but it's the words that are written about it.
Exactly.
So when Grumpy Cat then has become a meme... So Grumpy Cat is a meme, whereas there are many images of the Grumpy Cat meme. Many different, diverse images of the Grumpy Cat meme.
Hmm. Okay.
I guess I see
where you're coming from there. I don't know if I agree with it. But the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
Don't worry, everybody else does.
One of those.
And I'm King Mark, so I can just make it a declaration.
This is one of those things that does change over time.
Well, you know, that's King Mark could become a meme.
Could.
Or has it already been?
Oh, no, I think King Mark is already a meme. It's just not a very popular one because it's an idea.
Have people been making pictures out of King Mark?
They haven't. It's still an idea.
All right, guys, get on it. You've got your homework for this evening.
Until it gets popular and people start making text images with your picture on it, it's not a real meme. 855-450-FREE. Now anyone can go to websites like Quick Meme, upload your picture with you as the king, and start texting.
Hi, my name's Cody, and I want to tell you about Peacekeeper. Peacekeeper is the world's first decentralized peer-to-peer protection system. We are developing a smartphone app that revolutionizes how people protect one another. Peacekeeper is a disruptive alternative to the status quo.
Peacekeeper is a leap forward in protection services, allowing neighbors to respond far more quickly than police and fire services can. And this is a real community builder, too.
Visit peacekeeper.org and join us.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, June 30th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.72 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,172 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $264. Antiwar.com reports weekend reports of a planned Turkish invasion of Syria, aimed primarily at attacking Kurdish forces there, are now being denied by officials who say they instead will be building up security along the border in areas the Kurds control. The rhetoric generally continues, however, with one Turkish newspaper declaring the Kurds in Syria more dangerous than the Islamic State, and officials very publicly taking the U.S. to task for its growing aid to the Kurdish YPG inside Syria, seeing it as a threat to Turkey's border. Turkey's policy in the Syrian civil war has been informed almost entirely by its desire to weaken Kurdish secessionist movements there. So far, however, that has left the Turkish border with the Islamic State, Al-Qaeda, and a large Kurdish autonomous region where Syria once was. And while the U.S. and Turkey's other regional allies see the Islamic State as the biggest problem right now, Turkey clearly views the Kurds as the biggest deal, and with the U.S. backing those Kurds in hopes of weakening the Islamic State, they're effectively making the YPG an even stronger faction. Turkey has gotten itself into another corner with this policy, however, as while they try to sell a buffer zone carved out of Syrian Kurdistan for refugees, the reality is it will weaken the Kurds and, by extension, take the pressure off the Islamic State, meaning Turkey will almost certainly be alone in supporting this policy.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports police in Vicksburg, Mississippi arrested two people after a team of ghost hunters discovered the body of a woman Sunday at the abandoned Coon Memorial State Hospital, reputed to be one of the state's most haunted sites. The group found the body of 69-year-old Sharon Wilson lying outside the old hospital, though police said blood trails indicate that she was inside the building at one point and appeared to have head trauma. David Childers, co-founder of the Mississippi Paranormal Research Institute, was not among the ghost hunters who discovered Wilson's body, Police Chief Walter Armstrong told WAPT-TV in Jackson that Raphael McLeod and his nephew Akeem McLeod were arrested and faced charges related to the woman's death. Police said the McLeods confessed to breaking into Wilson's home, kidnapping and robbing her, but they said that they left her on the side of the road. The two had been arrested after they were pulled over for reckless driving and were discovered to be allegedly driving Wilson's vehicle. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. Reuters reports the U.S. Supreme Court on Monday found that a lethal injection drug used by Oklahoma does not violate the U.S. Constitution's ban on cruel and unusual punishment, a ruling that provoked a caustic debate among the justices about the death penalty in the U.S. The 5-4 ruling prompted Stephen Breyer and Ruth Bader Ginsburg to say for the first time they believe that capital punishment, as currently practiced, may be unconstitutional. They are the only members of the court to have expressed such views. The decision was a defeat for death penalty foes and for the three death row inmates who challenged the use of a sedative called midazolam as part of Oklahoma's lethal injection process, saying it cannot achieve the level of unconsciousness required for surgery, making it unsuitable for executions. Justice Samuel Alito, writing on behalf of the court, said that the inmates had failed to demonstrate that any risk of harm was substantial when compared to a known and available alternative method of execution. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
George W. Bush may be retired from politics, but he's keeping busy with his new hobby of painting. Today, the Picasso-in-Chief tweeted his latest picture, a turkey sandwich and glass of lemonade in front of the ghost of the Iraqi child that follows him everywhere. Rebecca Mira has been following the flourishing art career. He's pretty good, Rebecca.
Yeah, well, Rachel, Bush doesn't claim to be a great artist, but as he put it, not bad for an old man, huh?
Not bad at all. He says he likes painting simple things he sees in everyday life, like his dogs, that dead Iraqi child. You can see that Bush's art is improving over time. If you take a look, at first he could barely draw the Iraqi child's transparent hands, but now they look much more realistic.
Much more. You know, I'm not surprised that he's getting better. Bush practices constantly.
And Laura Bush says he's more focused than ever, locks himself away for hours at a time, and won't talk to anyone while he's painting.
Yeah.
Makes you wonder if history will look back on Bush as a politician or the next Rembrandt. Up next, a study found that drinking red wine once a day can help the body get hammered.
This is the Onion News Network.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, launching into the third hour here. We've got plenty of time for you if you want to share your thoughts with us about whatever's on your mind. That's the point of Free Talk Live with you tonight. You got me, Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
All right, we're going to continue with your calls. Coming up, more on Greece. I said that we were going to talk about what's happening with business owners there. We've mentioned previously on last night's show, Mark, you weren't here for it, but Derek and I talked about the situation in Greece where they're restricting ATM withdrawals. By the way, it's Ian, Mark, and Conan in the studio here tonight. ATM withdrawals are now locked down to 60 euro per day, as I understand it, in Greece. And there are even more controls that have been put on bank people with bank accounts there. And it's really hurting business owners. I'll explain to you what that is here in a moment. And you can join us here. We're going to go to the phones and to the fun first. We got H. Reardon on the line from Tampa Bay. You're on Free Talk Live. H. Reardon.
Good evening.
Hello.
The reason I called is to say that in many South American countries, there are people who fly rebel flags.
Really?
And in those countries, yes. Because here's why. In those countries, it's not considered racist. And it's because there are people in those countries who are the descendants of Confederate soldiers who relocated to South America after the war.
Yep.
And many of those people are very proud of their Confederate heritage. In fact, in Brazil, every year they have a Confederate festival in which people fly Confederate flags. There are people who dress in Confederate Army uniforms.
And the gals in the big dresses, too.
yeah, they have the antebellum type dresses. But the thing is, even in European countries, it's not considered racist. There are people, there are grave sites in some European countries that have Confederate flags because there are people such as, like in Poland, for example, there was a guy whose name was Hieros von Borki, who in his lifetime he was German because that part of Poland was part of Germany, and he came to the Confederacy during the war to offer his services to the Confederacy. His descendants, they put Confederate flags next to his grave. So it's only, it seems to be, in the United States that someone would be considered a racist to fly a rebel flag.
Interesting.
Yeah, I just looked these guys up. The descendants are called Confederados.
Huh. Yes. How many of them went down there? How many Confederate soldiers?
10,000 Southerners who immigrated chiefly to the area of Sao Paulo, Brazil.
Wow.
This is just Brazil.
So Sao Paulo, yeah. Fascinating.
Yeah, it happened all over, actually, you know, all over South America. And I mean, you know, to some extent, they're sort of scorned because they lost. And, you know, I mean, they also went down there because the labor was cheap, too.
Interesting. H. Reardon, want to share anything else?
No, I just wanted to point that out because I don't think a lot of people realize that.
Yeah, I'd never heard of that before. It's interesting.
How someone in the United States sees it, but people don't realize how people in other countries view it.
Right. Yeah. This is just like what Mark said. This is just like what Mark says. You got to walk in the other man's shoes in order to understand the other side of the argument. Otherwise, you're just, you know, it's just your opinion. And, you know, what does that all mean?
Yeah, a lot of people just don't want to do it, though. So I'm not going to run from the idea that the Confederacy certainly has some, you know, bigoted roots to it. You know, many of the states listed the whole, you know, slavery thing as one of the reasons that they were seceding. They were very clear on it. But at the other, on the other side, there were some taxes that were levied by the United States on basically southern states, agrarian southern states, which they all were. And that drove them away, too. So if people, you know, sort of stepped back for a second instead of just sort of pounding their drum on this issue, then, you know, they'd be better off.
H. Reardon, well, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-453. We've got Skype as well, by the way. If you want to join us on Skype, our Skype username is lrn.fm. In the very beginning of the show, we were talking about Bitcoin and how it is skyrocketing in popularity in Greece right now. Of course, if you've been listening to the last few days worth of Free Talk Live, you know we've been following the situation in Greece. And, you know, what's essentially happening there is there's a currency crisis, if you will, which, of course, inevitably will happen to most government-issued currencies at some point. In this case, the folks in Greece are being cut off from the euro, or it's getting darn close to that happening. And there's a bank holiday that's been put in place, which sounds like fun, but really it's not at all. People have a real tough time in these circumstances, and we'll talk about what's happening to Greek business owners here in a moment, why it's very, very difficult for them to get through this. This is not a good time over there in Greece, but some people are finally using this opportunity to look into Bitcoin because you can't get to your bank account. They've literally closed the banks. They've put in restrictive ATM controls, not even allowing you to pull out more than 60 euro at a time or per day from an ATM. And so Bitcoin, you want to go and transfer Bitcoin around? You don't have to ask anyone's permission. There's no banker holding the keys to the vault. You have the key to your Bitcoin account. You are your own bank, essentially, when it comes to Bitcoin. And so this is a real solution for people. Now, as the article over...
Well, here's another solution, too. I've just found an Indiegogo campaign where you can just send money to help support the Greek government's bailout fund.
What does that mean? What do you mean? Give money to the Greek government so they can pay off their debt?
And the socialists can stay in power and continue their irresponsible behavior.
Oh, the socialists will stay in power.
Does
it
say who's hosting this donation site?
Indiegogo.
I mean, but who set it up? Maybe it's the Greek government who set it up for themselves.
I don't know. That'd be even funnier.
You can rest assured, Mark, the socialists are going to stay in power in Greece. Maybe not this particular batch of socialists, but somebody likely with a socialist mindset is going to be swept in there in the absence of whoever it is, Spiros or whatever his name is right now.
Tom Feeney, spelled the T-H-O-M, and that's not pretentious at all, fellas. Thom Feeney from the UK got it started. It looks as though, my God, there's a half a million euro in this thing.
So now what they're pointing out here at CNN Money is that, well, by the way, half a million euro isn't even going to be coming close to helping them pay off the $1.6
billion. I'm just surprised anybody would throw this at it.
That's going to pay, what, 20 employees for the 4 year for an annual salary?
They have to pay $1.6 billion.
Yeah, that's what they're trying to put together, $1.6 billion.
By Tuesday or by today, basically, and that's not going to happen. And that $1.6 billion is only a fraction of the total bailout money that they've gotten. So it's only a portion, a very small portion of the total amount that the Greek government owes to its creditors. But that aside, there's some legitimate critiques that they have here over at CNN Money. And they're pointing out that, as they documented last year, it's difficult to live entirely on Bitcoin. So yes, Bitcoin is one way to protect yourself from the government. But given that there are only a handful of businesses in Greece that are accepting Bitcoin, changing all of your euros into Bitcoin may make, you know, may not make life that much easier. But one thing it definitely does is it insulates you from the depredations of the state, from the dangerous, stupid, insane economic things that the state actors and their buddies in the banking system can and will likely do to your bank account. That is something Bitcoin can protect you from right now. Now, as far as Bitcoin being very useful on a day-to-day basis in the streets of Athens, that's another question. Probably not so much. However, I think it's important to point out, as CNN points out here, they did a story about trying to live on Bitcoin exclusively back in late 2014. But remember, we're talking about Bitcoin time here and internet time. Half a year in Bitcoin internet time, there's a lot of important developments that happen. And maybe it was difficult to live exclusively on Bitcoin back at the end of 2014. I know our buddy Derek J has basically been living on Bitcoin for a couple of years, so it's certainly something that can be done. But as long as you're not a total purist, now they've got interesting tools that can really assist you and allow you to live on Bitcoin. So let me give you an example. So basically CNN Money is saying, oh, well, you know, these people in Greece, yeah, there's some good reasons to get Bitcoin, but you can't live completely on it. Well, yeah, you can if you've got the WageCan card, which I just got one of those a few weeks ago when we had John Bush came here on the Bitcoin tour they were doing, and he introduced us to the WageCan card. I can now spend with this WageCan card, which is a MasterCard that is fueled by Bitcoin. I can go and spend my Bitcoin on anything. Sort of, right? So what I'm doing is I'm loading the Bitcoin with US dollars by sending, I'm loading the card with US dollars by sending Bitcoin to it. I'll explain a little bit more here in a moment. Basically allows me to buy anything I want with my Bitcoin. It's Free Talk Live.
Every summer we go to Canyon Woods. Love getting outside. Love the hiking. Hate the itching and irritation from poison ivy, bug bites, all the things that keep me inside. So I need something strong.
Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing is clinically proven with the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief of itching and irritation with 7 moisturizers to help heal skin.
I finally have the relief I need.
Hey, Jan, check this out.
On my way.
Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
Discover how deep your American roots go for free this 4th of July weekend. Go to TryAncestry.com to get free access through July 5th. Visit TryAncestry.com anytime this Wednesday through Sunday, and you'll have free access to our collection of records from the original 13 colonies and with a new visual story experience. Celebrate this 4th of July and take advantage of this free access weekend. Visit TryAncestry.com. That's TryAncestry.com. TryAncestry.com.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233. 1-800-237 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As good as gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
The easiest thing in the world for a reader to do is to stop reading. According to the late, great Barney Kilgore, who became managing editor of the Wall Street Journal in 1941 and grew the paper's circulation from 33,000 to 1 million by the 60s. And he'd be pleased to know that his paper is one of the few that people now pay to read online. Someone else pre-internet who realized that attention is fragile? Motown Records founder Berry Gordy. In the early 60s, when his label dominated the charts, he'd bring a dozen real people into the Hitsville, USA studios and audition songs. And he'd ask, if you were down to your last dollar, would you spend it on this record or would you buy a sandwich? Today, attention span seems like an oxymoron. For tips on cutting through the clutter, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. We got time for you if you want to join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And joining you here in the studio tonight, it's me, Ian.
And Conan.
And Mark.
And Peacekeeper 2.0. It's not out yet, but they are working on it, and they need your help to make it happen. If you remember, we've talked about Peacekeeper 1.0 when it came out last year, and it's a great concept. It's got the potential to be world-changing. And the idea behind Peacekeeper is to decentralize emergency response. Now, I'm not saying that the 911 responders are useless, but it can be frustrating when you call 911 and it takes them a long time to respond. What if you could actually bring your friends, your family, your neighbors in on an emergency situation? Could they get there faster? Yeah.
Even if the police and fire and emergency services respond in their normal response time, they're not going to respond as quickly as a neighbor is generally.
Right. That neighbor could get over there, grab a hose, and possibly put out the fire before it guts your home. You know,
having put out a fire myself for the fire department, I can tell you getting there makes all the difference. I was first one on scene, and yeah, it makes all the difference. If that fire would have gone further, it would have engulfed the whole house. If I'd have been there 2 minutes before, that room might have been salvageable.
So Peacekeeper can change the world, and you can help by contributing to their Indiegogo campaign. They're looking to fundraise to hire a brand new developer to create a powerful bug-free system, because there were some problems with Peacekeeper 1.0, and they want to fix those issues, and they need your help. You can get some perks, of course, by donating at pk.freetalklive.com. Now, that doesn't take you to our website. It's just a forward that'll take you right to the Indiegogo campaign. PK, like Peacekeeper, pk.freetalklive.com. Go ahead and help out Peacekeeper, and you can help change the world. If you want to help Peacekeeper 2.0 revolutionize what protection means, contribute to their Indiegogo campaign today and get perks at pk.freetalklive.com. We've been talking about Bitcoin as a solution to the people in Greece.
We were also talking about WageCan. I'm at their website right now. Have you this is a card that you just picked up. It's a Master debit card, a MasterCard debit card.
That's correct.
And so you've only had it for like 2 weeks now?
No, I've had it for probably a couple months maybe. It's been a little while since John Bush showed up here. It takes a little bit to get one of these things, okay? So you go to wagecan.com. They're not a sponsor, by the way. I'd love for them to be one, but they're not.
I'm working on it.
Really cool folks. It's a group from Taiwan and Hong Kong. And basically, WageCan is sort of an interface company between you and a Hong Kong bank. So the Hong Kong bank, in this case, a bank called Transforex, they issue this card. They're the ones with the deal with MasterCard. So what WageCan does is they essentially take Bitcoin from you, and then they basically give cash to the Hong Kong bank. They then put that cash on this card account. So essentially, I can send my Bitcoin into WageCan, into just a regular Bitcoin address, send it into that address, and in about a business day, that Bitcoin will be converted into U.S. dollars and loaded onto this essentially prepaid debit card. And this thing works at almost every place I've tried it.
That accepts MasterCard debit cards.
Almost everyone. The only places it hasn't worked have been the Statehouse cafeteria, and I think I screwed something up when I was at CVS. I need to try CVS again. I think I pressed the wrong button on their little thing. And whenever it doesn't work, I just always want to pull cash out rather than try it a second time. So I haven't
gone. You don't want people to wait behind you,
yeah,
that sort of thing.
Domino's Pizza, Hannaford Grocery. I mean, all kinds of big places I've been to and spent this. Mom and pop places as well. I've been trying this wherever I can try it out just
neat.
To see if,
yeah,
it,
this is really neat.
If it works. So this is why I was saying when CNN Money says, oh, it's difficult to live entirely on Bitcoin. Not anymore. Not if you have one of these cards. I mean, what place doesn't take MasterCard, right? So this basically bypasses the need to convert your Bitcoin to cash because it's automatically being done behind the scenes over at WageCan. And on top of that, the thing that really impressed me about WageCan, Conan, was the fact that they're not charging you fees out the wazoo here, right? Like, so there was some, I remember years ago, maybe you recall this, Mark, there was the proposal to have a gold-based credit card,
yeah,
where you would put gold in some sort of an account and then they would sell the gold at a market rate whenever you made a purchase, and then, you know, that would fund whatever you were buying, essentially. And it sounded like a really cool idea.
Until you looked at the fees.
Until you looked at the fees and it was like, why would you do this? Why would you want to spend your gold in this way? It's going to cost you more just to spend the gold. Now, with the WageCan card, there is probably some kind of fee at the point of conversion, I think, when you're converting from Bitcoin into U.S. dollars. But once those U.S. dollars are loaded onto the WageCan card, there are no fees unless you go to an ATM and take cash out.
Mm. Yeah, there's an ATM cash withdrawal fee.
$3 or 1%, whichever,
yeah, 1%.
Is lower or higher, one or the other. So I was really impressed with that. I'm a huge fan of it. And so that would allow anybody in Greece or in any other situation where there's restrictions on bank accounts, anybody in Greece who's got a WageCan card can absolutely, you know, spend and buy whatever it is they need to buy. So the solutions are there. And the Bitcoin economy is coming out with these things all the time. WageCan isn't going to be the only company doing this. There's another one.
They're going to jump on that bandwagon.
Right. There's another one that I know about that has plans afoot to come out with their own Bitcoin loaded MasterCard as well. So, you know, we're just scratching the surface of what Bitcoin can do for people. And now the people in Greece are desperately trying to get their hands on Bitcoin. According to CNN Money, they talk about how Bitcoin was created as an independent computerized money in 2009 to provide a stark alternative to government-issued currency held at banks. This could be its moment to shine, writes CNN. But keep your wits about you. Flip Gadecki, the spokesman for the BitCurex marketplace, said it's unrealistic to think Greeks everywhere will suddenly ditch the euro and start conducting business in Bitcoin. And he's absolutely right about that. He says, I'm not so sure Greeks will start buying cheese with Bitcoin on Wednesday, but I think something has changed in their minds with the bank closures. Greek people will start thinking about fiat currencies as something not so safe for savings.
The minute the cheese guy starts accepting Bitcoin for his cheese, they will start buying cheese with Bitcoin if this situation continues the way that it is.
It could make all the difference. And that term fiat currency, many people don't even know what it means. Like they're not even familiar with it.
What does it mean, Mark?
Fiat currency means a currency that is created out of fiat, and a fiat is a dictate from a king.
Right.
And
the wave of a hand.
The slash of a pen creates more. And that in this case, it's just computers creating it whenever they feel like, and it's made by the Federal Reserve or the Euro Central Banks or whatever it is. But these currencies are backed by nothing. And that's what it means. Bitcoin is a currency of value because there is there's a limited amount of them. They can't be inflated, and they can't be broken. So they are a piece of computer code that has so far done exactly what it's supposed to do.
Well, to say they can't be inflated isn't an accurate statement. There is a set inflation program. Right.
They
in
can't
Bitcoin.
Be inflated by fiat. How's
correct.
That?
There is no government who could decide.
The king can't inflate this money.
Right. No, not even the Bitcoin programmers really can, because it's been sort of preset in the creation of Bitcoin. Yep. So we know there's X amount of Bitcoin today, and we know that by 2140 or whatever, that all of the Bitcoin will likely be mined into existence. And at that point, there will be no more inflating Bitcoin.
At this point, with our lifespan, we don't have to worry about 2140.
Well, you never know, Mark.
I'm getting to 2140.
There's always
Mark.
That possibility of machines.
I'm the only
augmenting.
One here who's actually paid Alcor to have my head cryogenically frozen.
That's true,
so
you have.
You people are just yicking.
855, 450 free. Join us here on Free Talk Live. There's more coming up. What's happening with the Greek business people? They're getting screwed.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle, now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com, onesilversolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
More and more people are discovering the incredible benefits of alkalizing the body, and there's no better product for it than AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops. Packed with a powerful combination of the most alkaline minerals and compounds, just a few drops in water will rid your body of harmful waste and give you more vibrance and vigor than you've had in years. Now buy two bottles and get $10 off your order. Call 800-518-7615 or visit alkavision.com. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at alkavision.com.
Free Talk Live.
The people that fought the Korean War and, frankly, the Afghan War won because those people are the military-industrial complex. And what they wanted is they want things that go boom to go boom so that they can build more things that go boom. That the purpose of the war isn't freedom. It's not justice. It's not any of these higher concepts that, in fact, that the lives, minds, and bodies of the people that are going out there and fighting for these wars, that they are inconsequential to the politicians and the people for whom they work.
So you're saying the state won these wars, Vietnam and Afghanistan. The state won, but the individuals who fought the war, they're the ones that took the brunt of it. They're the ones that lost.
That's right.
And I totally agree. They do enough to make it seem like they're doing something and to keep us happy enough just to control it.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
In every age, a technology is created that upends the foundations of society. The wheel, the printing press, the internet. Now, in a world sliding into financial chaos, a new technology is changing the way monetary systems work around the world. It is called Bitcoin. Bitcoin is a new form of money controlled not by banks, governments, or corporations, but through mutual commerce between free individuals. To learn more, visit weusecoins.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Hey,
who do you think you
excuse
are?
Me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this hospital.
Now, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make...
Wait a minute.
Now.
Wait a minute.
Whoa.
Hey! Oh, my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared of me.
Property,
what am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
With more Free Talk Live, and you can join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight in studio, you got me, Ian.
And Conan.
And King Mark the First.
All right. In a match between Conan and King Mark, I would side with Conan, I'm afraid.
I don't know, but other people out there are already accepting Mark's King image as their profile image.
Disturbing. It's very disturbing. Mark Warden has added your image as his profile picture.
The Porcupine Realtor, yeah.
On Facebook.
And he did it before I put out the homework assignment to start working on your King Mark meme.
That's
pictures.
Right.
All over Porkfest, as I was going around with my crown, people were, I'd say, you know, greetings. Loyal subjects. Mm-hmm. Greetings, loyal subjects. And they'd bow and they'd attempt to kiss my ring, which I really don't have one. And these sorts of things. And yeah, I mean,
it could have just been humoring the crazy man.
What do you think kings have been all along?
Usually the best way to get along with a crazy person is to just go along with the show. By the way,
what do you think they're doing with the police, my friend?
When the Department of Revenue thugs came on, what is it, Monday? Did you have your crown on during that?
I did. I was there before everyone else. I saw them pull into the parking lot. So Ian was, I tried to text him, but Ian was a little behind. And they really descended like locusts upon them. But as they got out of their car, I said, "I am your king," to them, and briefly got just a glance from one of them, and he just sort of went on about his way. But I find it interesting that these people who arbitrarily claim to rule over others think that a guy in a rubber crown is somehow crazy for arbitrarily claiming to be their king.
So let's talk about what's happening to the business owners there in Greece. It's worse than you might have thought, because we've been discussing what's been happening there with the currency crisis, if you want to call it that. There's a bank holiday that was supposed to just be Monday, but then Monday they decided to make it 6 days, six business days. So it's the bank holiday is going to last the entire week. And along with that, there
are
a
lot of barbecues, Ian, a lot of beer drinking and barbecues and celebrating the Grecian flag.
Well, the bankers may be celebrating because they actually have the ability to get their money out during the bank holiday. But everybody else in Greece is basically screwed. There are some serious restrictions that have been put down. One of them that we've been talking about is the fact that you can only take out 60 euro at a time from an ATM. And I think it might be per day. And that's pretty inconvenient. But that's not the worst of it. Here's a story from The Telegraph in the UK. As one of Athens' top florists, Dimitria Trino is the first port of call for anyone needing bouquets for a big fat Greek wedding. On Monday, though, as her country teetered on the brink of financial collapse, her prospects of a prosperous summer of nuptials were looking distinctly slim. She says, quote, "We do a lot of flowers for foreigners who like Greece as a wedding location. And today we have had two calls from people saying they are canceling their plans because they fear the country is becoming unstable." She said, "We expect there's going to be more in coming weeks, too," meaning more cancellations. Yet, even if her other clients do not choose to cancel, Ms. Trano now faces a separate problem for any customers needing her services in the next couple of weeks. As part of the ruling, the Syriza Party's efforts to stop a run on the country's currency, it declared that all banks would remain shut until next Monday, the day after the referendum on whether to accept the Eurozone bailout deal. So again, the voters in Greece on July 5th are going to be voting, I think that's actually going to be Sunday, They're going to be voting on whether or not they should be going on further and, I guess, accepting the terms of the next bailout. So the people who are the creditors of Greece, the 19 countries in the Eurozone and the IMF, they're willing to continue with more bail, you know, with further money to be poured into the Greek system. But along with that money comes all kinds of austerity measures. So people in Greece will be voting on whether or not they're willing to accept those austerity measures coming up on Sunday.
These are the people that voted in these...
the socialists.
The socialists, because the socialists were talking about not accepting the measures.
Yeah.
Now, I don't think that every person in Greece thinks like the voters think, but I suspect that it should be a very interesting election.
It is. And so, again, banks are closed until at the earliest Monday, when they finally will know what the vote is. Now, that move also prevents Greek firms from making payments to other companies abroad. Think about that for a moment. The restrictions on banking include a restriction preventing you, if you're a business person in Greece, from paying anyone outside of Greece.
Well, you got to keep the money in the country.
That's the idea here, okay? And so, according to the story here, for florists like Ms. Trenot, who imports much of her stock, there is now no way for her to pay for her bouquets of roses from Ecuador and hydrangeas from the Netherlands.
Hydrangeas.
She says, "We're one of the best florists in the country, but soon we will not be able to pay for our flowers anymore. It's not an urgent problem for us quite yet, but it will be in the weeks to come." Unquote. True, a lack of garlands and bouquets for weddings and funerals might seem the least of Greece's problems right now, but the story is the same for every other Greek firm too. And with not a single company able to pay a foreign creditor until next Monday, business leaders are warning of serious damage to an already ailing economy. Or as Konstantin Miklos, president of the Union of Greek Chambers of Commerce and Industry, put it, "We are stuffed." And I think stuffed might be a colloquialism for screwed there in Greek.
It might even be a little harsher than that.
Yeah, the Greek economy is not production-based, he told the Telegraph. It's highly reliant on imports of goods and raw materials. In other countries where capital controls of this sort have been put into place, businesses are usually exempted, but not this time. If we can't make electronic remittances, then soon even the most basic goods will not be available. Can you imagine? You know, how long are there the people they are doing business with going to be willing to send them product for free, essentially, until someday in the future when they might be able to make some electronic payment to make good for it?
They won't.
Yeah, not for very long.
That's it. Yeah, and I mean, import and export is really good for an economy, and this is what many of the isolationists don't understand. I'm by no means an isolationist. I believe that our government should stay the heck out of other countries' business around the world, but I don't think that our businesses should.
Indeed, over the weekend, there were isolated reports of customers stocking up on staples like rice, spaghetti, and tinned milk in some supermarkets, and of motorists queuing for petrol at garages on some of the Greek islands.
Tinned milk?
I don't know what that means. Tinned. T-I-N-N-E-D.
That must not be... We buy ours like in carton, condensed milk in like cartons and stuff.
No, condensed milk is in cans. Generally.
Oh, okay.
On Monday, supermarkets remained well-stocked in Athens, although there were fears that shortages could begin later in the week. Yet even if the banks do reopen as scheduled next Monday, it may take at least another week to clear the massive backlog of transactions. No economy functions without banks, says a senior MP in New Democracy, a center-right opposition party. Some people in Syriza think shutting them down for a week is just a minor hiccup, which isn't surprising as many Syriza people have never worked in the private sector. But it's not a hiccup. It's a huge shock. Well, certainly an economy can work without a bank, but given the current status of our economic situation, we tend to rely on banks for a lot of things. And because not everybody is using Bitcoin, this is a huge hit. Now, if there's a business person who's paying their vendors in Bitcoin, they've got no problem. Nothing would stop. If this lady had been paying for her flowers in Bitcoin, presuming her, you know, the people selling her the flowers are willing to take Bitcoin, then she'd be fine. She'd be able to continue paying for her inventory, and she'd get, you know, fresh flowers in every day she wanted them. And further, if it's a situation where she has an order of flowers that she has yet to pay for and now cannot pay for them, so she owes, was what sounded like was the situation. She owes on flowers that have already been shipped to her, but she can't make the payment on those flowers. Maybe that'll give that company that's selling the flowers in the first place the incentive to figure out how to take Bitcoin.
I would imagine that... I would think Amazon might get into this too, with you know, purse. Anybody through purse at this point can buy whatever they want. I would think in Greece, so that makes it. There's a lot of things you can buy, and if all
purse is international, you can definitely use purse.
If all your competitors, you know, are stuck because they can't send money out, then you know at that point pricing isn't as much of an issue because people still want what they want.
The atmosphere on the streets, meanwhile, remains tense with long queues continuing to form at ATMs. We'll talk more about what's happening in Greece, and you can share your thoughts at 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number here on Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius. zog.ninja. Code FTL.
Hey guys, I'm Tim Baker.
I'm Daniel Brown.
And I'm Sean Stewart.
And we are the You, Me, and BTC podcast.
Cryptocurrency decrypted.
Us three chumps love to talk too much, and for some reason other people seem to enjoy it.
That's why we started You, Me, and BTC,
which is your Bitcoin and Liberty podcast.
Find our show at youmeandbtc.com every Thursday.
We also post Bitcoin-related reviews, opinion articles, and much more.
Subscribe, like, and follow at youmeandbtc.com.
Now, a twice-as-nice twin-kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals twin-kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price, $89.95. But now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the twin-kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of ionic silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited-time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for under $30,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet under $30,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait.
Call 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You're listening to the best Liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
We're back now with Free Talk Live, and you are invited to join us here if you want to discuss whatever's on your mind or what we've been talking about, which is the situation in Greece and how it is really hurting the Greek businesses. Turns out one of the restrictions, these capital restrictions they've been putting on at banks, is preventing business owners from sending money outside of Greece. So if you are importing product in to sell in Greece, you can't pay your suppliers now, at least until this situation clears up, which at the earliest is going to be early next week. But as was pointed out, there's so many backlogged transactions, it may take another week just to clear through all of those. So this could really seriously inconvenience people. And of course, who knows what's going to happen in a week's time? Things could get even more insane over there. I mean, it's not likely. I don't think that the people in Greece are going to vote to accept these austerity measures, but who knows what's...
I don't think there's a car that hasn't been flipped yet
in
Greece.
A lot of that going on right now?
Well, yeah. It's usually, especially if it's government vehicles and buildings.
I haven't heard about much rioting going on.
Have you seen video?
I know that in France, the taxi cab drivers are rioting right now over
against Uber.
As far as this week, I'm not sure, but in the last months, yes.
Okay. Those Europeans will flip some cars. There's no doubt about it.
So that's what
you can't get Americans to flip cars over nothing.
Oh yeah, they'll flip a car over.
You're right.
Sports games.
Sports games.
Games. Yeah.
Pumpkin Fest.
Yeah. So that's what we've been talking about here. But you can bring up whatever you want. We've got Skype as well. Skype username LRN.FM. Free Talk Live brought to you by Keenvention. It's coming up at the end of October. It's October 30th through November 1st this year. It's the third annual Keenvention. And we just announced on Keenvention.info, Halloween is coming back. This year, Halloween, it's going to be a more private event. Last year, it was open to anybody who walked up with $10. This year, it'll be only for Keenvention attendees. It's pretty much who attended last year anyway. And last year, we did a fundraiser for the Ross Ulbricht Defense Fund, which went very well. We raised more than $500 for Ross Ulbricht's Defense Fund from a relatively small party with probably no more than two or three dozen people attending it. And so come on out. Join Keenvention. It's a great opportunity to come explore New Hampshire. Maybe you couldn't make it to the Porcupine Freedom Festival or Liberty Forum this year, which are two excellent yearly events thrown by the Free State Project. You boycotted Porkfest.
Oh, a little bit, yeah.
You were not boycotting Keenvention, though.
Oh, hell no.
So Keenvention, great event. It's a small event. It's an intimate event. I think it's the right term for it. I think last year and the year before, we had just over 100 attendees. It makes it so you can actually meet everybody if you want to. You can really kind of get to know people better, whereas at Porkfest, you can't possibly meet everybody because there's, you know, 1,500 or 1,300 people there. So Keenvention, very, very intimate. You'll hear from the activists. We don't fly in any fancy speakers from the rest of the United States or anywhere else. It's New Hampshire activists are the ones who are up on the stage. That's what the curriculum is there. And you actually get out of the hotel and go out, and if you want, you can go and Robin Hood with the Robin Hooders and get out and do some other fun stuff outside of the hotel.
Or so we can go to Robin Hood Park and just chill.
You can do that too. You can do a lot of stuff. Keenvention.info. Go and check it out.
Hey, by the way, the Greek anti-austerity movement has been going on since 2008, 9, 10-ish. Mm-hmm. And yeah, there's been a lot of car flipping, a lot of Molotovs being chunked at police officers, and
they hate austerity.
Buildings set on fire. So yeah, there's a lot of video, there's a lot of pictures.
Really, I thought it was anarchists that threw Molotov cocktails. Apparently, it's statists too.
Yep.
So the atmosphere in the streets, according to the Telegraph in the UK and Greece, remains tense, with long queues forming at ATMs where customers are now limited to withdrawing 60 euros per day. Many pensioners who do not have cash cards have not even been able to do that. 74-year-old Anastasios Yveldis, one of about 100 retirees waiting outside the main branch of the National Bank of Greece, said, quote, "I came here at 4 a.m. because I have to get my pension." He says, "I don't have a card. I don't know what's going on. We don't even have enough money to buy bread." The finance ministry has said that special arrangements would be introduced for pensioners without bank cards. Also apprehensive was Vasilis Repanis, a wine seller who said that orders were notably down for Monday's annual June 29th celebration of St. Peter and St. Paul's Day, in which people bearing those names receive gifts from friends. He says, normally we do about 25. This year, we've done just 7. He says, I'm 36 years old, and this is the first time I feel anxious about this crisis. I've heard all the warnings over the years, but now it finally seems that it's happening.
It's going to happen here, too, in the U.S. It's going to be the same thing. We've been hearing about this forever and ever and ever, and I wish I'd gotten into Bitcoin when Ian Freeman came by our store that one day here in Keene and tried to get us to start shopping with it.
Boy, I wish I'd gotten into Bitcoin earlier, too. Mm-hmm. But the sense of foreboding was echoed by Mr. Mitsotakis, the MP, who said the only hope now is persuading Greeks to vote yes to a bailout deal in the referendum. He says, we need to get this matter resolved once and for all. Syriza, keep talking about a humanitarian crisis in Greece. Now we are really facing one. And so, unfortunately, it's like this for people. It's not until the last moment when people actually really realize
Sure. They
better figure something out or else.
Yep.
And it's getting pretty dire, these circumstances over there in Greece. It's fascinating to watch, like a train wreck is fascinating. And hopefully it's instructive for people. Like, hey, this could happen where you are. And Conan, you said it could happen here, but here they have the ability to print their own money. Right. So the government can sort of stave off these kinds of things with all manner of manipulation of their system of money. But in Greece, they're dependent on the eurozone situation.
Yeah. But what about competing currency around the globe? Because other countries are starting to say, hey, you know what? Hey, we don't have to deal with the Federal Reserve note. We've got the Chinese. What is it? The yen. We've got
How do you pronounce yuan? Is it pronounced yuan or yen?
Okay, the yen is part of the yuan, the same way that
it's part of it. Okay, I didn't know that.
So they're like, you know, why deal with their nonsense? We could do the same thing on our end of the our side of the wagon, and you know, once the Federal Reserve note starts to lose its flavor and its power, then yeah, it can definitely happen. And you can only print it so many times. You can only inflate it so many times.
Well,
and
as they
so
found
many
out
zeros.
In Zimbabwe, that's certainly
and before
that's
you know, you're buying bread in wheelbarrows with wheelbarrows of cash.
But at the very least, you know, the U.S. guys are money manipulator masters, right? Like they've been putting off the end of the dollar for a long, long time. And maybe it'll all wrap up next month and we'll have a similar crisis.
Well, no, we're going to have to go to war with those competing currencies.
What do you mean?
World War III is going to be about competing currencies with these other countries who are going to start doing the same thing that the U.S. is doing.
You think the U.S. will start a war over people bailing on the U.S. dollar? I guess they could.
The claim is there's some curious conspiracy theorists out there, and I haven't really been able to disprove this, that claim that essentially all the wars in the last 5 decades or so have been fought over, to some level or another, the banking systems of countries that wanted to get out of the petrodollar system.
And current wars with current countries who don't want to have anything to do with the globalized currency and want to have their own currency. Or as soon as you have some dictator who wants to start dealing in gold and wants to get out of the current currency, next thing you know, he's getting dragged to the streets by his own people.
There's no doubt at all that the ISIS right now is creating a gold dinar. But I mean, you know, that's kind of part of the Islamic religion is sound money.
Well, as far as the U.S. government pushing around other countries is concerned, sure, they can go and throw their weight around in Afghanistan or Iraq or some small place like that. But you don't think they're going to go to war with Russia?
Well,
China.
They sure are trying to demonize Putin and the country that they're
Ukraine?
Ukraine. Ooh, okay. Wow. Yeah, I've been working too long today.
Well, yeah, they're trying to demonize him, but that's, you know, it's important for the U.S. to appear to have enemies around the world because it's valuable for fear-mongering purposes, right? But the realistic chance that they're actually going to go to war against a country that could actually have a chance against
them? I don't know. War makes a lot of money. That makes a lot of money for...
Yeah, but they make money when they're dominating one of these other countries.
Russia
right?
doesn't have a chance in a land war against the United States. It's really about nuclear weapons, Ian. Mm-hmm. It's not a chance. It's a chance to blow up life on the planet. So, no, I don't think the United States will go to war against the Russia.
Yeah.
But I think that they will put a great deal of pressure on them, and they're already beginning, to some extent, to buckle to that pressure. They're feeling the heat.
Russia is?
Yeah, to some extent. They're feeling that it's difficult to be on the wrong side of the United States. You know, obviously, if you don't have a nuclear weapon, then you're going to, you know, you're going to get it worse.
What about China, who has invested heavily in the in our money and in our real estate in some instances? You know,
yeah, you really wonder. I mean, to some extent, it's to their benefit to keep the U.S. dollar going. To a large extent, it's to their benefit to keep the U.S. dollar going. So I don't really see China necessarily trying to undermine the dollar. But maybe I'm wrong on that. They could certainly have a benefit to seeing the yuan, you know, get more powerful.
Check out more of Conan on his website, blacksheeprising.org. Fresh episode coming out this week, right?
Yep.
You recorded it last night, so just within a matter of days over at blacksheeprising.org. Check them out there. And more Free Talk Live online between now and tomorrow night at freetalklive.com.
Hi, my name's Cody.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, June 30th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.72 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,172 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $264. Antiwar.com reports weekend reports of a planned Turkish invasion of Syria, aimed primarily at attacking Kurdish forces there, are now being denied by officials who say they instead will be building up security along the border in areas the Kurds control. The rhetoric generally continues, however, with one Turkish newspaper declaring the Kurds in Syria more dangerous than the Islamic State, and officials very publicly taking the U.S. to task for its growing aid to the Kurdish YPG inside Syria, seeing it as a threat to Turkey's border. Turkey's policy in the Syrian civil war has been informed almost entirely by its desire to weaken Kurdish secessionist movements there. So far, however, that has left the Turkish border with the Islamic State, Al-Qaeda, and a large Kurdish autonomous region where Syria once was. And while the U.S. and Turkey's other regional allies see the Islamic State as the biggest problem right now, Turkey clearly views the Kurds as the biggest deal, and with the U.S. backing those Kurds in hopes of weakening the Islamic State, there are effectively making the YPG an even stronger faction. Turkey has gotten itself into another corner with this policy, however, as while they try to sell a buffer zone carved out of Syrian Kurdistan for refugees, the reality is it will weaken the Kurds and, by extension, take the pressure off the Islamic State, meaning Turkey will almost certainly be alone in supporting this policy.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports police in Vicksburg, Mississippi arrested two people after a team of ghost hunters discovered the body of a woman Sunday at the abandoned Coon Memorial State Hospital, reputed to be one of the state's most haunted sites. The group found the body of 69-year-old Sharon Wilson lying outside the old hospital, though police said blood trails indicate that she was inside the building at one point and appeared to have head trauma. David Childers, co-founder of the Mississippi Paranormal Research Institute, was not among the ghost hunters who discovered Wilson's body. Police Chief Walter Armstrong told WAPT-TV in Jackson that Raphael McLeod and his nephew Akeem McLeod were arrested and faced charges related to the woman's death. Police said the McLeods confessed to breaking into Wilson's home, kidnapping and robbing her, but they said that they left her on the side of the road. The two had been arrested after they were pulled over for reckless driving and were discovered to be allegedly driving Wilson's vehicle.